Horlick Field in Racine. It's time for the North American Football League. Ah, they're tailgating. They're ready for football in July as the Wisconsin Bulldogs get set to take on the Racine Raiders. Hi, everybody. I'm Bob Brainerd. This is former Badger, former Packer, and current co-host of the Gary and Cliff Show on Sports Radio 1250, WSSP, Gary Ellerson. Gary, these players tonight, they don't get a single nickel to play football. A lot of these guys, they're doing this simply to keep the dream alive and simply because they just love this game too much.
Bob, you got to give it up to these guys. I mean, they have jobs, they have families, they have babies, and yet these guys are him put on the line every single day for these guys. And you know, this is a great place to be. It is a great atmosphere. I'm glad to be here tonight with you, Bob.
Glad to be here as well. And history at this historic Horlick Field as well. The Racine Raiders, you may have heard about these guys, but their opponent tonight, the Wisconsin Bulldogs, used to be the Milwaukee Bulldogs. They're moving up into the NAFL from a AA affiliation, if you will, when they played last year. But Gary, tradition, if that means anything, the Raiders have it. They've won 7 national championships, their last one in 2001.
Look at the Racine Raiders in their program. You look at the Wisconsin Bulldogs. They're the new kid on the block. They may get a little lesson tonight from the Racine Raiders. I'm predicting the Racine Raiders win this game tonight, Bob, going away.
There's your prediction from Gary Ellerson. Let's head over to key on a couple of the key players tonight with Travis Kavinsky.
I'm Travis Kavinsky here to talk to you about two key players to watch. First from Wisconsin Bulldogs is wide receiver Antoine Burns, number 18. The University of Minnesota spent time with 3 different NFL teams as well as an arena team. And now he's spending time with the Wisconsin Bulldogs. The other is number 81 from the Racine Raiders, Dorian Palmer, wide receiver, who last year had 747 yards, 14 touchdowns, and he carried that same success over the season. Now back to you, Bob.
Travis, thank you very much. Gary, you had 7 knee surgeries. Are you recovered? Are you getting ready to relive the dream?
No, I'm all done, Bob. I'm right where I need to be, right here with you on the sideline, buddy.
And you are right here on opening night as well. Sit back and enjoy the North American Football League. It's the Wisconsin Bulldogs and the Racine Raiders, and the kickoff is coming your way next on Time Warner Sports. Back here at historic Horlick Field in Racine. Bulldogs and the Raiders opening night. They play a pair of preseason games each. And now we do it for real. Racine coming off of a 2006 campaign where they were 15-4, but no consolation to them because as Gary and I talked in the open, they're used to championships and their last one was in 2001. And this is even a different team than the 2006 squad. It's a little faster, according to the head coach and all the previews. But that being said, they also need to quit giving up points, Gary, because they've given up a bunch in their first 2 games, one of them going to overtime. They defeated the Michigan Admirals 50-44 in OT, but then lost Northern Michigan Force 48-28. So the defense has to tighten it up. The offense can score some points, but we're starting from scratch now, so
well, that
game
was,
on.
That was preseason, too.
It's preseason, but like anything else,
this is
right?
For real tonight, Bob, so it's a little bit different. You got to tighten the screws up. You throw some guys out there, try to give them some playing time. So that could be a little deceiving. Tonight is for real. Tonight you go out, you let it all hang out. Great crowd here tonight, Bob. I mean, a lot of people are in the stands. Stands are packed. It's going to be an exciting game.
And a beautiful night for football, Gary. You can get anything in July in Wisconsin, as you know, and we've got a perfect afternoon and a perfect evening, and the Bulldogs will kick off to the Raiders. They'll be going left to right, and the 2007 season is underway. Back deep and ready to bring this one back, Sam D'Elia at the 20. Makes a cut to his left, 25, wrapped up there, fumbled the football.
What are they calling it?
He heard a whistle blow.
Fumble. Wisconsin Bulldogs ball, buddy.
Yeah, one official blew the whistle and said Racine keeps it, and then the other one came running in and said, nope, ball loose. And they're not going to check the replay with our truck. They're just going to make the call and give it. It'll be first in Wisconsin football after they kick off at the 26-yard line.
Yeah, not a good way you want to start out here. And he just got hit low and just kind of lost the ball there, Bob. You know, when you're playing football like that, it's quite simple. You got to be able to hold on to the football. Nothing extraordinary about that.
He's got good speed. He played his football at Horlick High School. And you'll see him on offense as a wide receiver, but also in that tailback position, but trying to return that kick and trying to make it something happened. He lost the football. So it's the Bulldogs first and 10 at the 26. On the turnover at the quarterback, Mike Bogzuski. Played his football at UW-Oshkosh. Going to throw on first down. Intended over there for Tim Booth, the big fullback out of the backfield. It'll be second down and 10.
Yeah, what you had there basically is a sprint right play. They're trying to flood out the right zone over there and trying to get that big fullback out for a pass and fell incomplete.
Wisconsin, as we mentioned, they went by the Milwaukee Bulldogs last year. And, in fact, they were in a different league. They were in the IFL, the Ironman Football League. In fact, they were the Ironman Football League champions the last 2 years. And time is called. One of the officials, Mike Brewer, along the sidelines, going to go over and confer at the formation. But Milwaukee, in that Ironman Football League, a so-called double-A level, if you will, if you take it in the baseball stages, this is considered the triple-A of minor league football. In fact, they have a saying here, Racine, minor league major heart.
Yeah, this is a big step up for the Wisconsin Bulldogs. It would be nice to see if they can come out and get something sustained right here. They have great field position right here, Bob. Let's see what they do. They look like to me they're in an I-Pro set predominantly.
Not sure what the delay is. They went over to the Bulldog sideline and talked with head coach Dean Tuttis. Now we're set. Second down and 10 for the Bulldogs at the 26. And the give to the big man in the backfield. That's Michael Harrell. Tried to fight for yardage, tried to cut the sideline, maybe picked up about a yard. It'll be third down and 9.
You know, we talked to Coach Kopick before the game, and they sent the house on them. We said their defense is going to be out. They're going to be getting at the football a little bit and surrounding the football. You had number 20 coming up the middle, and number 52 stayed home, and they just stretched that thing out for the guy.
Yeah, Nate Harris, the big linebacker who played football at Carroll College, stayed home, as Gary said. Third down and 9 now for the Bulldogs at the 25. Trying to cash in on the immediate turnover on the kickoff are the Bulldogs. Dropping back, firing into the corner. This one into the sun. It's going to be incomplete. Good coverage over there by Tracy Baskin, the defensive back from St. Catharines High School.
Yes, it was. You know, he did not get beat deep and kept the guy in front of him. And Tracy had good coverage on that play. Bob, and you know, their defense looked pretty good. Looked like they're up to the task today. Looked like they're up to the task.
So it brings up fourth down. Calvin Thomas, the intended receiver over there, is trying to beat his man in the corner and throwing into that as well. That didn't help the cause for the Bulldogs. So they're going to attempt the field goal here. It'll be a 43-yard attempt for Jason Borchert. Jason did his booting at UW-Platteville back in the day. This one from 43. Kick is up,
nice
long
leg.
Enough, and it's good.
Oh, my.
So a little more than a minute into this contest, and the Bulldogs strike first on the turnover on the kickoff. They put three forward and lead it 3-0.
I will still say that will be a victory for the Racine Raiders. They didn't get six. They kind of stopped them. They held them ground. So, you know, getting a field goal is not really a big deal for the Racine Raiders there.
So Wisconsin strikes first. There you see the head coach of the Raiders. In fact, he is Raiders football. Jordan Kopack.
Yes, he is. You know, he's been here since 1964. Well, actually got started here in 1964.
Yeah, he was a player for the Raiders back in the day. We were chatting with Jordan before the contest, and he said, I've been here my whole life and in many capacities, but he's on his second stint as the head coach of the Raiders. 68 years old. Doesn't mind telling us that as well, because it just goes along with the territory of having the veteran experience behind you.
Well, you know, let's see what Sam Dialli can do for us this time. See if he hold on to the ball, because you know what? I'm sure going to kick it to him if I'm the Bulldogs.
Yeah, Dalia's deep again. And he's the lone man deep at about the 3-yard line. And he'll get another chance perhaps, but this one bounces out of the end zone. So Dalia won't touch it, but the Raiders will set up shop first and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Now keep an eye on this first play. We're privy to a little inside information from Coach Kopak, Gary. They've got a play that they run here, the very first play of the ball game on offense, and he says over the past couple years, they've struck for six about six, seven times. So.
Yep. Six touchdowns here. They're going to run a little bunch formation, going to try to get into some trips with a little motion and try to catch them off guard. Let's see if it works.
See nine men stacked up at the line and one man in the backfield for Dan Novotny, who's under center quarterback. Now keep an eye on this play. Novotny barking out the signals. There's the fake. Now he goes to the safety valve. And it's incomplete, intended over there for D'Elia. Now that's exactly what happened, Gary. The play broke down that way where they bunch up and then they break off. And if a man is deep and open, they can go to him, but the Bulldogs were ready for it.
Yeah, they stayed home. I mean, the guys in the secondary stayed home. You look at that play, it was okay. It didn't catch my fancy like I thought it was gonna do. But DJ Rugisker back there, he stayed home at that safety spot and did not leave home.
And Rugisker is an interception machine. Always dangerous to throw in his neck of the woods. Second down and 10 from the 20. Again under center. And you want to talk about veterans. Novotny is just that. 39 years old. He'll be 40 in November. Quick screen pass. Dish over there to DeAndre Hatch. He played his football at Milwaukee Washington High School. Pickup of about 2 yards. It'll be third down and eight.
Yeah, that's a great play by number six, Dominique Ross, for the Wisconsin Bulldogs. Came up and laid the leather on it. And you know what? These Wisconsin Bulldogs seem to be fired up a little bit here, Bob.
And the team is the Bulldogs. And you got to play like one, don't you?
And that they are.
Third down and seven. Passing situation here for the Raiders. Novotny's got wide receiver split to each side, and they'll run the football, trying to plow for yardage. And Brian Jennings did what he could, couldn't bust. Fourth down and five from the 25, Raiders will have to punt.
I tell you what, I'm impressed. First series on the defense for the Wisconsin Bulldogs. They kind of stood in there, and then they bent a little bit, but they didn't break. They're not afraid of this Racine Raiders team there, Bob.
Joel DePry back to punt. He played football at UW Parkside and Racine St. Catharines. He was also a soccer player. And timeout called by the Bulldogs. They want to make sure they got the numbers on the field.
They had too many guys out there on the field. They didn't know their personnel a little bit. They got guys running in and out of there.
Yeah, and it's opening night. Stuff is going to happen. Got to make sure that everybody's on the same page. And that's a penalty you don't want to take because that would have given first down at the 30. So they burn a timeout to get the personnel straight, and DePry will reset and try and boot it away again. Get a look at some of the fans here. They're looking into the sun, but they don't mind. Little breeze blowing in from the north end zone into the face of the Raiders currently. And that's where DePry will kick into that. Not a gale force by any means. We're not that close to the lake here in Racine, but if you get it up in that jet stream, it might bring it back a few yards.
Flags
fly. DePry's kick, fielded at the 40. Ross.
Got a little room.
Makes the cut. Check that. Antoine Vance makes the cut, gets it across the 50 to the 45, but we will check the flag. Oh, in fact, that's Dominic Ross on the return, but we'll go back and check the flag. Referee is going to sort things. Flag flew immediately after the snap. DePry and the Raiders signaling that it's against the Bulldogs, and if it is, it'll be a first down. And they will keep the football.
Yeah, let's see if they can sort this thing out here. It's also probably the first game for the officials too, Bob. They've got to sort things out a bit.
Indeed. Well, they're the only guys who are getting paid.
All right, first down.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, the call. So somebody apparently went flying into the line because that's where the flag flew. Did a little extracurricular trying to get in there and block that punt. And it's too bad because it erases a decent return by the Bulldogs that would have seen them set up shop at about the 45. Seen instead, the Raiders keep the football and they get it first and 10 at the 31.
Let's see if the Raiders now can get out the football and grind it a little bit, because they have an advantage on the offensive line versus the Wisconsin Bulldog offensive line. Let's see if they can grind it out a little.
Yeah, you noticed that. There's some big gubbas up front, aren't there?
They're kind of healthy up front, Bob.
So Raiders keep the football, first and 10 out at the 31 for Novotny. In motion is Schapveld.
There we go.
And here's Jennings. Pounds his way up 3 yards. It'll be second down and 7. Jennings going to do the majority of the work in the backfield for this Racine club that Coach Kopak told us he likes to try to run, tries to, about 60-40.
He's trying to run to the soft spot each and every time, but you see the Wisconsin Bulldogs, it appears that they're running defense with four defensive linemen and three linebackers, and they have a strong safety that seems to be going to the strong side here. That will be number 37 for the Wisconsin Bulldogs, Mike Stewart.
Call it second down and 6, maybe. Novotny, quick pitch.
That'd be a quick trap play up the middle.
Josh Macara out of Elkhorn High School. Big 5'11", 275 running back, getting the quick call.
Mm-hmm. You see, that's a quick trap. You got number 52 pulling there, and he takes that guy out, and big seam up the middle there.
And Darius Jones is 52 for the Bulldogs. He grabbed that jersey, and if he doesn't, perhaps a much more on that play. Third down and 1 now for the Raiders, and now whistles. And a timeout called by the Bulldogs. They burned their second timeout. So we'll step aside. Big play coming up on third down for the Raiders. It's the Bulldogs 3-0 in the first quarter here at Historic Horlick Field. We'll be right back with football. And we're back. Third down and 1 play coming up for the Raiders. Bulldogs down to just 1 timeout remaining in the half. They've burned a couple trying to make sure that the proper people were on the football field. And here are the Raiders, who are trying to take advantage of a penalty on a punt to keep this drive alive. Novotny fakes.
Misdirection here.
Yeah, misdirection. Jennings. Down and more for Jennings into Bulldog territory at the 49.
Good play by them. Good play by Jennings. Play by the Racine Raiders. They had everybody bunched up in the middle. Had everybody bunched up in the middle. And ran like a counter, almost like a trap, where a little misdirection play where Jennings had some good yards there. A little misdirection. Good play for the Racine Raiders there.
So they get that yard and then some. The football just crossing the midfield stripe here at Horlick Field. Raiders down 3-0 here in the first quarter. D'Elia lined up in the backfield now, along with Jennings on first and 10. Big tight end in motion, and that's D'Elia. Looks to cut the corner and does. Pick 5 yards, it'll be second down and 5 at the 45.
That good piece of running there, a little toss sweep there to the right side. Little toss sweep, get the blockers out in front of me and turns it straight up, get north and south. I like when you see a runner get north and south and not try to round the bounds and get all he can. That was a great run, great game by them.
You like that, but did you run north and south when you were playing football?
Every single time, buddy.
I know.
Better believe it.
I know. I just want to hear it from you.
Oh, yeah.
Second down and 5 for the Raiders.
I'm looking for them to take advantage of it. We got big number 85 down here at the bottom of the screen down there, DeAndre Hatch. Got him one-on-one just about.
Yeah, we highlighted the receivers from both these squads in this, but so far it's been the running attack, and it continues here as Jennings goes one way, cuts back the other, picks up the first down.
Another misdirection play by the Racine Raiders. Catching the guys off. Jennings doing a good job getting north and south, getting all he can. Well, like I stated earlier, you look at the Racine Raiders, you look at them up front, Bob, they clearly have the weight advantage up front of the offensive line. I truly believe that they can run the football anytime they want on the Bulldogs.
Brian Jennings, by the way, is a junior. His father is the Vice President of Operations Brian Jennings Sr. here with the club. He was a ball player for the Raiders back in the day of 8mm film, I'm told. Brian's rushed for 1,000 yards two of the past three seasons. And hoping to get the bulk of the carries again this year and put up another 1,000-yard season. Doesn't get a whole lot there. Why? Because number 95, Robert Taylor, who played at Illinois State, right there to greet him.
Basically, you saw Robert Taylor just really just out-muscled his man up front and got in the backfield.
So Taylor right there causing a loss of three. It'll be second down and 13 for the Raiders. Ball spotted at the 40-yard line.
I always hate when that happens to him, when it happens like that. Well, you know what? When it happens to you as a running back, you just go back to the huddle. You don't say anything to the offensive line because you know they're going to pick it up. They're going to get you. So you just go to the huddle, get ready for the next play.
Yeah, you just hate seeing that other helmet. You want to see one of your guys in the way of that other helmet.
Right, it happens sometimes.
Second and 13.
Here we go.
Novotny back to pass. Has to scramble.
Throws it away.
Just gets rid of it. Good decision there by the QB. He was in trouble. And no real safety valve over there. D'Elia, vicinity, but no chance to even find him to pick up some yardage. It's third and 13.
I don't know if you remember number 52 here. Darius Jones used to be an outstanding player. The same kid from Beloit Memorial.
I do.
Played football at Wisconsin, outstanding defensive lineman there. Had a lot of heat on him back there, making him rush that throw.
2 years starter for the Badgers, in fact. Third down and 13 for the Raiders. Big play coming up here to keep this drive alive, trailing it 3-0. Novotny gives it to Jennings. Not much there. Whistles blow and flags fly at the end of the play. We'll see what the penalty is all about. The Raiders deciding not to chance it and try and pick up that 13 yards. Instead, just trying to see if a hole would open up. It didn't. Uh-oh. And holding call on the play on top of that. The Bulldogs will wipe it off. They'll force fourth down and force the Raiders to punt. So DePra comes on to boot it once again.
All right, we'll see if the Wisconsin Bulldogs can maintain their composure this time on this punt. What do you think?
Yeah, they erased a good chance to have that football. Quick snap by the Raiders. DePra angling for that corner.
Nice pooch punch. Nice pooch.
Bounced at about the 15, 16-yard line, and that's where they'll mark it. And Bulldogs will set up. Once again, they are already lead it 3-0 over the Racine Raiders. We're coming back with more football from Horlick Field. We're back, first and 10 for the Bulldogs. Quick swing pass out there on the safety valve to Michael Harrell. Not much doing as the Raiders smell that play out. No gain for the Bulldogs.
Little bubble screen, Tracy Baskin kind of snuffed that out. For really no gain. They may have lost a couple on that. So far, I'm impressed with the Racine Raiders secondary. They have been giving up a lot of yards through the air.
Yeah. Gave up points and yards.
Yes, sir. Tonight, they're a little tight tonight.
44 in their preseason opening win over Michigan. And then in a loss, gave up 48 points. So a concern. Trying to tighten it up here. Second and 13. In fact, a loss of three. Flags fly all over the place as Harrell rumbles and stumbles his way out of bounds. We'll check the flags here. Might be on the Bulldogs.
Yeah, it could be. Although the Raiders were blitzing, they could have jumped off sides. See what they call it.
Harrell played football at Illinois Wesleyan.
Oh, okay. Legal.
Motion.
Legal procedure. Yeah,
motion penalty. Going to be called on the Bulldogs, so they'll step it back five more yards and bring up a second down and 18 for Wisconsin.
Those big offensive linemen get a little bit nervous when they start blitzing that up front and they get a little twitchy.
Always blaming it on the offensive linemen. ever anybody in the backfield.
No.
They're rock solid, aren't they, Gary?
Oh, yeah.
Waiting for the snap. So, in fact, they take the five-yard penalty, walk it off, 5 second and 18, pitch in the backfield, trying to cut the corner, and look out. More flags fly. Andre Dry from Joliet Junior College cut the corner, but again, flags, and it might be holding this time. Dry around the corner. But
yeah, you saw a great block by number 22. Tim Booth. Oh, the flag here.
In fact,
his hat.
Yeah, hats fly because they ran out of flags. And I think probably some unsportsmanlike conduct called as Antoine Burns, who we talked about in the open, had a few, shall we say, choice words for the referee. So this, the ball already spotted at the 8-yard line to begin the play. If the penalty is holding and then an unsportsmanlike conduct, they may be in the concession stand snapping this ball on second down.
They may be getting some caramel corn.
Well, they can't get that because you bought all of it.
Yeah.
We've got a couple tubs up here in the booth and guess all night to chow that down. Okay, so just as we thought, holding on the play and then unsportsmanlike conduct after the play, they do half the distance once and then another half after that, so the ball's gonna be placed at the 2-yard line.
Now they should be playing good defense here and try to contain, don't let them get them out. I really don't see the Bulldogs trying to pass out of this situation, Bob.
Dean Tuttis, the head coach of the Bulldogs, perhaps putting his hands up in surrender mode at this point. Second and 24. Just trying to get a little breathing room are the Bulldogs. The quick carry over there. Tim Booth, the big fullback, grinding it out for a couple yards, but it'll be third down and miles to go.
And he did about the best he can do on that play. You're right, Bob. They're just trying to get some breathing room for the punting team when they come out there.
Third and 22 from the 4, so.
Wouldn't be surprised if you see the same play ran again. Nothing fancy here.
Budzewski under center.
Oh, pass.
Gonna try to get fancy. To Burns! Almost came up with a circus catch. Antoine Burns over there, and how about the coverage by Tracy Bascom on the play to break it up?
Great play by Tracy Bascom. He was beat initially, but like a good cornerback, never gives up on the ball and got his hands in there to pry it away. Gutsy call by the Wisconsin Bulldogs. You would never see a guy try to throw the ball in his own 2-yard line. Now, if I'm the Raiders here, I may try to block this. Don't have a whole lot of room to work with.
Joe Zukas, Gary, is the big man punting, and he's in the shadow of his own goalpost, as they say. As the breeze begins to pick up here at Horlick Field, and probably just in time for Joe, who might get a little aid from Mother Nature once he gets this kick off. Wind at his back, gets it up in the air, and get some good footage on this.
Oh.
Fumbled over at the 50, but recovered by the Raiders. Picked up and taking it for more yardage is Nate Harris down inside the 30.
Big Nate Harris.
Nate Harris, Johnny on the spot to pick up the loose change from his teammate and make something out of nothing.
There you go. Took his eye off the ball, looked at the coverage a little bit, but you got big Nate Harris rumbling, stumbling, bumbling. I bet he was a fullback at one time, the way that guy ran that ball, that big Nate. The last time you ever carried the football, probably.
All those linebackers, they all want to carry the football. Kevin Barrett was the man who initially tried to field the punt, got popped, dropped it, but Harris helps the cause. First and 10 at the 29 for the Raiders. Novotny to Jennings. Jennings First down and more down to the 25. Brian Jennings doing the dirty work, using the blocks and the holes in the offensive line.
Nice cut by Brian Jennings up in the hole, gets up in the hole, five of his blockers. I love this James kid. Every time you see him, Bob, he's running north and south. He never gets out of his comfort zone. He's never running wildly. He's always in control. Offensive line doing a good job in front of him.
They sure are. First and 10 at the 15. We talked about those wide receivers, but Racine happy to just keep it on the ground. This time they try to go to the air. Novotny, three pumps, and then it gets off in the end zone. Rugsegger is going to bring it out. He's got blocking, gets it out to the 27-yard line, and there's another pick for T.J. Rugsegger. Boy, Novotny pumped three, four times, tried to get an open receiver.
Well, it was a busted play from the get-go. He should have just thrown it away. He was trying to get it. He was trying to get it to his receiver over here, number 81,
Dorian Palmer.
And he probably should have just thrown it away and ate it, because when you got to pump it three, four times, you're gonna, you know, good's gonna happen out of that.
Yeah, Palmer was hung up in traffic, and when he couldn't get to the end zone and get free, Novotny should have just gunned it into the concession stand. And instead hung it up long enough for number one to make the pick. And so the Bulldogs, on another turnover, get the football back again and keep the lead 3-0.
Formation here by the Wisconsin Bulldogs.
Budzewski back to pass. Looks, goes left, intended for Burns. He's got him. And they'll whistle. 20, 15, 10, touchdown, Bulldogs. 73-yard hookup between Budzewski, Burns, and Burns, who tried to make the circus catch, couldn't that last series, makes this catch, and then stays on his feet and goes 73 yards for the score.
Not high school rules, not college rules. He actually falls down. No one touched him. He gets back up, take it to the house. The Raiders kind of gave up on the play a little bit, Bob. Cannot allow that to happen here. Great throw, though.
Watch Budzewski look right and then goes to Burns. There's
watch
the catch.
He falls, gets up, nobody touches him. Let's go, pro rules, touchdown.
Now you can make the case that the man that touched him forced him to roll on the ground, but the officials decided that there was enough separation there that the last time he was touched and that time he rolled to the ground, as the extra point is good, but flags fly. That's a tough call, because you can say that his momentum carried him and rolled himself on the ground, but give Burns credit for getting up right away.
Up on the play.
If anything, he sold the officials on it.
Mm-hmm. Didn't give up on the play on that one. Got a flag on the play here.
The kick was good. However, if it's on the Bulldogs, they'll have to kick it again, and it is. So they'll march this one back 5 yards, make it a little bit of a longer boot for Tim. Well, we talked about Burns in the open. He is electric. He's got the credentials, and he's been around, including some NFL experience. And, of course, that blazing speed that he had on display at the University of Minnesota, on display there, he got up off the ground. As Gary said, he took it to the house. Boots it. This one, so the penalty hurts the Bulldogs. They don't get that extra PAT on top, but they do get the lead bumped to 9. 9-0 our score, Wisconsin over Racine here in the first quarter in the opening night of the North Football League. By the way, Gary, I went to the site because that's what I do. Over 120 teams in the NAFL, conferences, 8 regions, 32 divisions, mm-hmm. and over 6,000 members on hand in this league. And they converge. They have a playoff system. They all converge and eventually meet in the World Championship game that takes place in Las Vegas in November.
That's a good trip in November.
Not bad.
Especially if the Raiders make it, that'll be a good trip for them. But the way they're playing right now, they're not going to go anywhere. I mean, you got a team like the Wisconsin Bulldog, which is actually they're playing up, so to speak, in a new league. They played in a lower tier league last year. And these guys are coming out and laying it on the line, and the Raiders seem to be resting on all the championships they have won in years past. That doesn't play for you.
He's
got to get out and play.
And, Gary, a lower-tier league, as we mentioned, kind of the double-A level.
Right.
But, again, these guys were the champions, national champions at that double-A level.
Right.
So it's not like they're not used to winning and not used to playing at a very high level of football. The kick fielded at about the 5 on the backhanded catch by comes all the way across the field, gets it out to the 40, 45, finally knocked out of bounds at the 48-yard line. Good field position on the good kick return by Kevin Barrett.
Did a good job of returning this. Looked like it was a middle wedge up the middle, and he busted out to the side. No containment on the right side over here. The guy did a good job of making the play all alone. Barrett did that basically all on his own. Good piece of running by him.
The special teams has been on display on both sides of the football here tonight.
Good field position at the 50-yard, 49-yard line here.
See what the Raider offense can do. They the field a whole lot with nothing to show for it. Trailing 9-0 here in the first quarter.
They burn another one?
And if the Bulldogs burn it, they're done here in the first half, and we haven't hit the gun of the first quarter.
What's the call?
Well, timeout call by somebody. But we will keep it here. But as we mentioned, again, the North American Football League, which is a, they call it a self-sustaining level of adult football, allows players to develop their skills or simply participate for the love of the game, as Gary and I were talking about. And again, the players don't paid. The coaching staff doesn't get paid. I mean, I don't think Gary and I get paid either.
No, we don't get paid. Do we get paid?
You're eating your paycheck.
There you go, yeah. Karma corn.
Yep.
All right, here we go, Bob.
Great summer evening here in Racine, near the lake, Lake Michigan. And they've done a lot of renovation here at Historic Horlick Field, as you could see. Brand new bleachers on both sides and brand new lights to go with it as well. Jennings, again, busts up the middle, running north-south, as Gary says. About 4 or 5 yards, it'll be second down and 5.
They've dominated line of scrimmage, but they have nothing to show for it on the scoreboard. Unfortunately, turnovers have absolutely killed the Racine Raiders today.
Yeah, turnovers have been crucial here. And lots of penalty flags as well for both teams. Novotny checking that wristband for the plays. Coach Kopech telling you, Gary Ellerson, that he's pretty much got about the first 30, 40 plays scripted for this contest.
Right. He's running off a master list and it doesn't deviate.
Second and 6 for Novotny.
Draw.
Draw and then a fumble.
Gets it back.
Good break. Josh Makara out of Elkhorn got the draw, got the hole he wanted, then lost the ball. But luckily, the only people there were red shirts. Makara got it right back in his breadbasket.
If he doesn't fumble the football, he's taking it to the house. I mean, there was nobody. That hole was huge. He just lost. It just squirted out of his hand.
Irv Crawford, number 53 from Concordia University, reached back and might have tipped that football, but it was hard to tell. But a lucky break, 33 gets it back and gets down on top of that. First and 10th of 39. Makara again, fly again.
Inside trap.
Pickup of only about 2 or 3.
So fast, somebody had to be offside.
If it's offsides, the Raiders will take the 5 yards and keep it first.
There we go.
That's your man, Chris Jones, jumping early.
Yeah, he's trying to get there.
So it stays first down. Ball marked at the 34 with 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. And the Bulldogs on top, 9-0. is the man at the bottom of the screen. At the inside is Palmer. The lone two receivers to the left of Novotny on first and five. And here's Jennings, first down and more.
Unbelievable.
Well, you gotta like the way that he runs, yeah. Gary, because he's got a burst. And as you said, he doesn't deviate.
No.
He keeps goal post in that end zone.
Here we go again. Straight up the gut. They clean it out. The offensive line doing a good job of blocking up front. I mean, they football at will. They just got to eliminate the mistakes once they get down in the red zone. They seem to stall when they get to the 20 and in.
Yeah, don't get fancy if you're Racine. Just keep doing what you're doing.
Pounding it.
First and 10 now at the 24. Those big two receivers at the top. Again, the give to Jennings. Gets about 5 yards on the carry. 20-yard line, and they are indeed in the red zone now. Second and five at the 19.
You know, when you're in a football like that, if I'm a running back, I keep telling the coach, let's keep running, coach. Just keep moving it. I mean, they got a good groove. They got a good thing working out. They can just run down their throat if they choose to. O-line's got to keep coming off the line of scrimmage, so they're doing a good job up front.
They mark it at the 20-yard line, second down and six for the Raiders. Palmer at the top of the screen, Hatch at the bottom. But it's been the guys in the backfield doing the dirty work. Jennings again, but Darius Jones says not this time. Jones blew it up at the line and came in there and sacked him for a loss. Jennings has football.
Yes, he did. It got kind of bunched up at the line of scrimmage. He had no movement on the offensive line at that particular point.
First quarter in the books. It's the Bulldogs on top after 15 minutes. Nothing. We're returning with more football from Racine on Time Warner Sports. Third and eight from the 22. Big play for the Raiders here to start the second quarter. Novotny pumps, scrambles, fires into the end zone. DeLeo wide open, touchdown. Oh, the little pump by Novotny. Screen, and DeLeo got free. 22-yard hookup between Novotny and DeLeo, and the Raiders are on the board first time in 2007.
Well, the pump fake worked that time.
Yeah, I would say. Ask the Bulldog.
Yes. Great play. I mean, what you got here? And I think it was just a pump fake. It was a hitch and go. And the cornerback came up for the hitch, and DeLeo got behind him. Great catch by him. Great pass.
Yeah, Novotny. You saw the pump fake like he was going to do the quick strike to DeLeo, and then DeLeo busted off. And when the defender bit, that's all they needed. 23-yard touchdown. The PAT is good. And all game on here in Racine. 9-7 our score now as the Raiders get on the scoreboard. That time, they take advantage of good field position, march it downfield, and put it in for six. Well, that time, it was the running game setting up that pass play.
Mm-hmm.
As you said, just do what you're doing well, and they went right down the field. Got them in the field position with Jennings and company. Pretty work, and then that helped set up the pass play from Novotny to DeLeo.
Right, you know, what you've seen so far here in this ball game is that the Racine Raiders have been able to run the football at will, but they've been in the red zone 20 and in, they still seem to bog down a little bit. I mean, that was third down, a critical down that they made a good play on. But it just seems that the Wisconsin Bulldogs kind of bend but don't break kind of a defense, so they kind of letting you have some. But that was a good hookup by the quarterback and receiver on that play.
DeProw will boot it. Dominic Ross, the deep man for the Bulldogs, along with Antoine Vance. Vance played football at Whitewater, Ross at Iowa Central. DeProw with the back. This is Ross at the three. Block back to the middle. Hits it out to about the 26-yard line, and that's where the Bulldogs will set up first and 10.
Good coverage. Good.
So Wisconsin, in their initial game here in the North American Football League, top after one quarter, 9-0. But the first play of the second quarter, the Raiders got that touchdown to make this a contest.
Mm-hmm.
They'll spot it at the 25-yard line, and that's where the Bulldogs will begin first and 10.
The Bulldogs haven't really sustained a drive yet. It's been kind of a quick strike offense for them so far.
Crowd starts to make a little more noise here. Budzewski backs to pass. Fighting over there and making the catch, Calvin Thomas. Right into the sun, too. There's a piece of sun along the Bulldogs' sideline. Thomas is looking right into it. He fought off his defender and made the catch.
Good pick. Two-step drop, let it rip down the sideline. No doubt about it, great catch.
Eric Feast over there defending, but Thomas able to get some separation on the play.
And like we said earlier, their cornerbacks have been beaten in preseason, and nothing's changed so far.
Pickup of 23 in that play. First and 10 at the 48 of Wisconsin.
Double twins here.
Yeah, Thomas at the top of the screen along with... And before everybody can get set, flags fly. And plenty of penalties, Gary. Opening night jitters.
Mm-hmm.
This one whistled on the Raiders. So big Bulldogs get 5 yards free.
Yeah, big number 55, they say, jumped offside, which he did. But I think he thought the quarterback moved. The quarterback did move, but the refs didn't get it. So here we go, first and five.
And 55 is big Wilbert Kennedy. He's playing his 18th season with the Raiders. Should know better. From the 47, quick pitch and then blown up at the line. Jamie Isom right there out of Lewis University. The linebacker right there to stop him at the line of scrimmage.
They try to run a draw play here to Reggie Lawrence, and the linebacker did not take their proper steps, and they did not go for the pass fake. Stayed home.
Isom, 6 foot, 225 linebacker. Snuff that play out. It'll be second down and 5 for the Bulldogs. Stays at the 40. They spread two receivers to the left of Budzewski. And then Antonio Laster goes up to the right. Budzewski rolling, Isom chasing, and he completes it at the 35. Making the over there, Adam Zuniga out of UW-Whitewater. Good job that time by the quarterback Budzewski to get out of trouble with Jamie Isom right on his tail.
And really a breakdown of a play appeared because they had him dead left to right here. Scrambles out to your right-hand side. Wide open is Adam Zuniga.
Jordan Kopak telling us game that those linebackers on both sides, they blitz them almost every single time, yeah. Gary. And that, you saw Nate chain. Harris coming in from one side, yeah, along with Isom on the other side, and they had the play defended perfectly, but Budzewski did the job to get out of trouble and complete the pass. First and 10th of 35. Looks to his right, has to scramble out of trouble. Budzewski will carry the football. Picks up 5 yards, dance bounds. Good job that time by the Bulldogs QB to not throw that ball in the coverage, instead tuck it and go and pick up 5.
Very, very crafty quarterback there.
Oh, he's from Oshkosh.
He does a pretty good job making smart decisions.
And he picked up the, oh, check that, picked up 5 yards in the play, so it's second down and 5 at the 30.
He's not making a lot of mistakes.
Well, that's what you like. You like your quarterbacks, yeah, that can manage the, yeah, game. You hear that phrase all the time.
Yeah. Mike Budzewski is not making a lot of mistakes tonight, folks.
Second and 5 from the Budzewski.
Screen.
And throws that one away. Good coverage by the Raiders on that left side. A couple of receivers over there. But Budzewski saw the maroon jerseys in the vicinity and decided to just throw it into the ground. It'll be third down and 5.
They tried to set a screen over here to your left side, Bob, and Racine Raiders stayed home. They snuffed it out. And Mike Buzuski all night long was making right decisions and did not try to force it and threw it away. Smart quarterback there. Oshkosh guy, huh?
Oshkosh guy, yeah.
Yeah, that's what they do. Make right decisions.
Well, if they don't play, they call football games. That's why I'm up here.
Yeah.
Calvin Thomas checks in, number two, third down and five from the 30 for the Bulldogs.
Refs are meeting here, and they threw a flag.
What's this all about?
Oh.
Intentional grounding.
The smartness went out of the window there, buddy.
Now, I'll tell you what. How long did this decision? The Bulldogs were almost up to the line to snap for the next play, and they call intentional grounding. They're going to have to go back and remind these guys which play they're throwing the flag on, because that 30, 45 seconds ago.
It took him a while to figure that out, but he had a receiver out here on the left side that he has some receivers out here to his left. And, he had two guys out there. I don't know how they call that.
Well, Burns is 18. He's definitely a receiver. Yeah.
Should I say a little home cooking?
You can. Well, it just... You can question the call, but it's just odd. It took so long to get the flag waved. Third and 16 now and for the Bulldogs. But Zutski comes back and finds Burns. He's going to be short of the first down. So they made something out of nothing, but they had an awful lot to get after the penalty. So now it'll set up fourth down. And what do we got, about 3-4 yards? Go.
If I'm the Bulldogs, I go for this. You got nothing to lose. They really hadn't stopped them all night long. They haven't stopped them all night long. You go for this.
Ball's at the 28-yard line of Racine. 3 yards to go. Kind of in that area where you're kicking a field goal into the wind.
Right.
Or you go for it, and I think that's a smart and easy decision. Fourth down and three for the Bulldogs at the 28. Watch out for Burns. But Zeus going to try. Instead, tries to go underneath to Santonio Laster. It's incomplete. Raiders will take over.
You know what? A heady play still by Mike. Had three guys over here in the flat that he could choose from to throw it to just on that particular time. It's tough for a right-handed quarterback to throw it to his left side. I tell you what, though, what's happening here outside linebackers for the Racine Raiders are absolutely losing contain. No containment outside. This guy can get outside anytime he wants. I don't know what kind of defense they're running, but I'm going to have to ask big number 56 over here shortly. There's no containment on the outside over there. Somebody's got to stay home at some particular time.
You're talking about big 56. He's up here in the booth next to you. Yeah.
He's got some big guns up there. Look at him. Look at them things he got there.
I was hoping you weren't going to run down to the sidelines and ask them what kind of defense they're running.
Woo!
We know what kind of defense they're running. It's a lot of tonight. Brian Jennings up the gut, picks up 2 yards. It'll be second down and eight.
You know what? You love when you got a big fullback in front of you like Josh McCara. Josh took the linebacker head on. Big collision. Sacrifice his body for the tailback.
You're getting lathered up, aren't you?
I might go suit up. Give me your jersey, man.
Defensive end, you can't let that quarterback roll outside of you. Safeties, I can't put a third guy on top. I run cover four and cover five, and you safeties are supposed to be over the top. What the f*** doing in the middle of the field when the ball's completed on the side?
As we eavesdrop on the Raiders defense, getting a little lesson. Brian Jennings giving a lesson to the defense of the Wisconsin Bulldogs. First down and more out to the 42. Big pickup again by Brian Jennings.
Here we go. Got another counter play by Jennings. Doing a good job getting north and south, getting all he can. Guys been running the ball hard tonight. Not a lot to show for it, though.
Raiders continue to move the football on the ground. Behind that man, Brian Jennings.
Saw our defense coordinator down there chewing a little butt out a little bit. Sometimes you got to do that.
Never the offense coordinator. You guys are always on the same page, aren't you?
Absolutely.
You just want the coordinator to come over and pat you on the helmet and say, good job.
Attaboy.
Offensive guys all together. Woo. Bouncing off the line and picking up something is DeMarcus Francis.
Nice job. Nice run by DeMarcus Francis. Nothing up the middle, busted to the outside.
Little change of scenery here. Francis, 5'5", 175, but he uses that tiny frame and the speed to bounce off the line and pick.
Very quick.
Pick up some yardage there. Got about 7 on the play. It'll be 2nd down and 3. Raiders inching closer and closer to midfield, trying to get into Bulldogs territory and trying to take the lead for the first time tonight. And now Dan Novotny will call timeout. We'll step aside. 18 to go here before halftime. The Bulldogs on top of the Raiders, 9-7. This is minor league football from Racine. If you're not to Raiders football just yet, you can always catch up on your novels.
I wonder what she's reading there. Women from Mars, you think?
I didn't catch the book jacket there, Gary.
I'm not sure.
I was hoping she was reading a program, trying to, you know, see who some of the new faces are for the Racine Raiders in 2007.
All right, here we go. 2nd down, big guy.
2nd down and 3 at the 48 for the Raiders. First burned by Racine. They've got 2 left. Wisconsin has just 1 here in the first half. D'Elia. And
great
nothing
play
there because it was blown up by Robert Taylor, number 95.
Great play. Great play by Vance over there. Stayed home. Number 5, that Antoine Vance. Great play. Stays home here. Comes up in your screen right here. Antoine Vance stays home. Great play by him. And that's what you want your outside line. Well, he's not really outside linebacker. He's a corner on that side, but he doesn't get beaten. Stays home. Contains that stuff. Keep everything inside.
So a loss of 4. Down in 7 and 4. You saw what they're doing with D'Elia. They line him up in that slot position, but they try to get him back at the tailback position, and that time it just didn't work. Novotny looks to throw, does, fires, and it's tipped and caught but out of bounds by Dorian Palmer. The old tip play, Palmer grabbed to keep his eye on the football, but he couldn't keep his in bounds.
Got a flag on the play back here, see what we got.
If it's on Racine, then the Bulldogs would just decline it and force the Raiders to punt, I'm sure. The ball was tipped by Dominic Ross down there. And Palmer able to reel it in, but he was well out of bounds in the play. And the yellow tees continue to fly. Roughing the passer called on Wisconsin. So a big call there. Instead of being forced to punt, the Raiders get 15 big yards, get into Bulldog territory, get first down, and get to keep the football.
Okay. All right.
Did they call it on Robert Taylor? He's got a big smile on his face. Usually the guilty party. So 1st and 10 on another crucial penalty. On the Bulldogs, ball spot at the 41 of Wisconsin. New life for Racine. Jennings the lone back behind Novotny.
Got double twins right and left.
That's D'Elia and Palmer at the bottom of your screen. Jennings gets the call and busts it through the line to the 30. Inside the 30 is Brian Jennings. 1st down for the Racine Raiders, and Brian Jennings having himself a big.
And what you saw they did there, Bob, they kind of spread everybody out, double twins right and left, and they ran basically a trap to the inside to Jennings. And once again, Jennings, once he gets out, he gets north and south and tries to get off. Same formation here, but from the shotgun. Shotgun, double twins, right and left.
1st and 10, 28 for Racine. Jennings inside and to the Novotny, and the ball squirts away. Novotny falls on it, and good decision by 15. He'll lose a bunch of yards, but it could have been much worse if he tried to pick it up and make something out of nothing.
Yeah, out of center there, and Novotny used that old St. Norbert's education and got smart and down.
That's where Dan played his football back in the day. We mentioned it in a couple months. Dan will celebrate his 40th birthday. So savvy veteran, good guy to have on this football team. All the young guys come in that are experiencing Raider football for the first time. Second and 27. Quick pass and hitch to Palmer, who back to the original. He's close. The mark at about the 33-yard line. It'll still be third down and about 13 for the Raiders.
This will be interesting. I think at this point, you'll probably see the Raiders go for it. Nice play here. Kept his head about him. Playing across the middle. Yeah, they're going to go for this. I don't blame him.
No, it's third down.
Sorry,
so
it's third down. Okay. Same formation, double twins.
Third and 15, they say, from the 33. Yeah, twins top and bottom for Novotny. Lots to choose from. He goes to the air, goes for D'Elia. Touchdown! Sam D'Elia getting separation second time tonight. He and Novotny hook up for another TD, this one from 33 yards out.
Great pitch and catch there by the quarterback and the receiver. Novotny to D'Elia. Got him down to the bottom of the screen, and look like he just ran just a straight takeoff route, straight goal route, and just got behind this guy, 37 there for the Bulldogs. Mike Seward is nowhere to be seen.
Wow.
I think they want to get the ball back.
Novotny and D'Elia, two times tonight, hooking up for TDs. The extra point is up, and it's good. And the Raiders grab the lead for the first time in 2007. 14-9 the score, Racine, Wisconsin. More football coming your way on Time Warner Sports when we return. Sam D'Elia getting congratulations from his head coach. And he's been patted on the shoulder pads a couple tonight. Mm-hmm. He and Novotny hooking up twice for touchdowns, staking the Raiders to a 14-9 lead here in the first half.
The game didn't start off very well, but I think he's came back and made some amends on this ball game so far. Started off with a fumble and kickoff return, but since then I think he's done a pretty good job.
DePrada kick. Boot once again. All the way back to the goal line, and fumbling the football is Vance. He recovers.
Loses contain on the outside over here.
Cuts around the middle to the 40. He gets popped by DePrada, the kicker.
The kicker making a play. Bob, what's going on?
I know you like that.
What's going on? The kicker's getting in there.
And a former soccer player as well. Those soccer players, they can mix it up. Watch Vance. He fumbles at the goal line, and then when it looks like the play is busted, he makes something out of nothing.
Well, they break containment over here, and he gets outside. And where's the kicker? There. And he calls a fumble too, big guy. Look at that. I like when the kicker get into
it. Oh, yeah, I like that. Joel DePrada.
Yeah, I like that. Kickers are kind of, you know.
Played high school football and soccer here in Racine.
Get a little squirt of water there.
Yeah, he's
pretty tough running down there.
He's gassed now after that play. Nice play by Joel. First and 10 at the 41 for the Bulldogs.
They said the Rays defense was stiffening up a little bit now.
Yeah, no gain on that play.
And what you're looking for, Bob, what is basically has happened to the Raiders, a couple things that happened to them defensively. You know, I said before, they're not getting any containment from the outside from their outside linebackers and their safeties over the top. They're not getting any help over the top from their free safety. Let's see if they solve that problem.
No gain on the play, so it's second down and 10 for the Bulldogs. Andre Dry in the backfield. He gets the pick, tries to cut, and does. Picks up about three, where a threesome of Raiders make the tackle. It'll be third down and 7.
Now, that was a lot better by the Raiders out on the left side. You had Jerome Isom staying home, getting some containment, and forcing it inside and being able to make a play out there.
So it's third down and 7 from the 44 for Wisconsin.
And that's what you're looking for, Bob. You're looking to keep these guys inside, not letting them get outside and contain it.
Bud Zuski.
Think this is a passing down for him?
I would say so. Burns is at the bottom of the screen, number 18.
Oh, my goodness.
And then the pitch the other way to Booth, who gets the first down and then some. Finally knocked out of bounds at the 35, but they use Burns at the bottom of the screen as kind of a decoy,
yeah,
thinking
did.
They might go to the left. That little screen to the right worked quite well, thank you very much.
Great play. You had twins left. You looked left and come back right. You little tailback flare out of the backfield on the right-hand side. Linebacker should have that guy man-to-man on the left side over there. I don't know what he was reading. Somebody let him go free.
Booth gets a breather. Did his job. The big fullback picked up the first down into Raider territory here with 3:05 to go before time. Harrell in the backfield again as Budzutski gets him set at the line. Calvin at the top of your screen. Burns at the bottom. And I thought that was coming. Too much time.
Well, no, illegal procedure. I believe they jump. I believe the Bulldogs are illegal procedure there.
Well, besides the penalties, Gary, what do you think about this brand of football? These are guys, keep in mind, by the way, as mm-hmm. Gary said, besides not getting paid, that they all have real jobs. They all have real lives. And mm-hmm. they practice twice a week mm-hmm. to get ready for their games.
To be doing a week, they're very competitive. And the guys seem to be knowing what they're doing. They're in the right place. I'm very impressed what's going on out here today, Bob.
And it is overnight.
Mm-hmm.
These guys have had a couple of preseason games, but when you play for real, as Gary said, it all bets are open. You go to your game plans that you hope work, and now another flag flies.
I believe they had too many guys on the field. That'd be the Bulldogs. I think too many guys out there on the field. Yeah, illegal participation.
Yeah, if you're not allowed to participate, then get out of the huddle. That's all I say. Well, the officials are getting plenty of airtime on Time Warner Sports, aren't they?
That they are.
First and 20 now as the Bulldogs go backwards once they got into Raiders territory. They still are, but he 20 for the first down. Budzinski over the middle of Burns, incomplete. Knocked down by Jerome Crawford. Right there, toe-to-toe and step-for-step with Antoine Burns.
Well, they're in a two-deep coverage here. They're cover two. You had two safeties over the top, and you had a good trail guy underneath, and that's the way to do it.
You saw Crawford running step-for-step and got the hands in there just when he needed to knock the football down. Second and 20 from the 45, 2:08 to go before the halftime gun.
They're going to throw it again. They tighten it up a little bit. They've taken some chances. They're in cover two again. Oh, now maybe not. They're coming up on a line of scrimmage here.
Burns at the bottom of the screen, along with Harrell on the inside. Budzutski goes the other way. Long over the middle and caught.
Interception.
And then picked off. It was initially caught, and then Eric Feast comes away with the pick.
Took it away from him, Bob.
Yeah, ripped it right out of his hands.
Yes, sir.
Donald Woods, the tight end, has the football at first, mm-hmm. but then watch Feast.
He just took it away from him. That's what happens when you're in the weight room every day, buddy.
Boy, what a play by Eric Feast.
Good
the 5'10", 185 defensive back from Concordia. Made the play after Woods made the catch. Boy, what a turn of events on one play.
And Eric Feast had been getting picked on a lot here tonight. Came up with a big play on that one.
So the Raiders, as we go inside of 2 minutes.
Here we go.
They get the football back and stop a potential drive by the Bulldogs that would have put them perhaps in the lead if they score a touchdown before the half. Instead, the Raiders get it to preserve the lead or perhaps add on to it, already leading it 14-9.
See if they go back or do they just want to go in at halftime up 14-9. We'd like to see them with 2 minutes to go in the game. to try to go for it, move down the football a little bit and see what they can get. Maybe they can get a field goal because they got the win here at their backs here. Let's see what they do here.
First and 10 at the 27. And a new quarterback in there, Brett Stava. And he gives it to Jennings.
And keep it on the ground.
So Statema, number 12, 6'1", 5. Little different look here on this final drive. Perhaps the hurry-up offense look. And Statema.
He's a hurry offense guy?
Could be.
And nothing appears to be wrong with Novotny because he's just staying up on the sideline over there. So
just might be the 2 minute offense out there. Statema running it. We give again to Jennings and nothing doing according to the Bulldogs. Irv Crawford there to grab Jennings, loss of one. It'll be third down and 8.
But unfortunately, the Bulldogs can't do anything. They can't stop the clock because they use all their timeouts. So now this is where it hurt them, and the Racine Raiders actually take their time and run some of the clock. They're going to have to punt it.
Yeah, they'll chew up as much time as they can as it comes over to get the play. Third down and 9 at the 28.
Well, if we can run around here a little bit, maybe they won't have to punt it.
Bulldogs still with one timeout yet still left, I believe. So they may call it after this play
pass.
If they can stop them. The pass to Jennings. Does he get the first down? It's going to be awfully close.
Now
he's going to be short about a yard.
All right, they're going to have to punt it. No, they won't. They ran enough time off the clock. They're all done.
Clock continues to run. So apparently the Bulldogs did burn all three timeouts in the first half. And if that is the case, that will be the half. It's fourth down and 1. Everybody watching the clock run down. And will that be halftime?
That'll
I
be
believe
halftime,
it
buddy.
Is. It is. Whistles blow. Teams head to the locker room. And at the half, seen on top 49. Gary, your thoughts on the first half? There were a lot of penalties called, but as kind of expected, but some explosive plays
well,
as well.
Well, good first half. I just think the Rays need to just throw up a couple of things. They need to get the linebackers contained. They need to get the safeties over the top. They should be fine. For the Wisconsin Bulldogs, I mean, they're playing very well. I mean, they're playing a lot better than I thought that they would. They're a feisty bunch of guys, and they're not giving up.
So our score, 14-9. We are standing by, hoping to hear from Travis Kavinsky, who's going to track down the head coach of the Raiders, Jordan Kopack, and get his thoughts on the first half of this one. See what the head coach of the Raiders had to say in the first half of the opening of the 2007 season.
I want to get a defensive coordinator. He had a little fire and brimstone thing going on over there. Hey, get him up there, boy. He was sure chewing some tail.
I think he had plenty to say, and we heard it. Here's Travis and the head coach of the Raiders.
I'm here with Coach Jordan Kopack of the Racine Raiders. Jordan, what do you think about the performance of your team in the first half, as well as the opposing team?
I think they're acting like they're in the twilight zone a little bit. I think we put enough yards up. We should have another 2 touchdowns or so. But that's part of the ball's not round. It's early in the season, and we'll come back second half. We're controlling the game. It's just a matter of the score is close.
And your thoughts of the opposing team?
Well, I think that they've got a good quarterback. They've got a good secondary with number one. They got some nice linebackers. I feel that they probably haven't spent a lot of time on their run blocking techniques in their running game. And that's really where the weakness comes in at this level of football, is trying to get a good running game in, because it takes so much discipline. And of course, we worked a long time on it.
And your thoughts, finishing up here, your thoughts, what are you going to do coming into the second half and making some adjustments to ensure the win?
Well, what they've done is they've rotated against where we run a wing instead of a tight end usually. They rotated their line against it, and now because we've been so successful, they've rotated their line back and their linebackers opposite. Okay. So what we're going to do, we'll do the opposite.
Okay. Hey, great job.
There.
Here. Travis Kavinsky live here at Horlick Field.
Travis, thanks very much, and thank you, Jordan. 14-9 score. They're playing in the Twilight Zone. Submitted for your approval. The first half, it's in the books. Second half coming your way. Stick around here on Time Warner Sports. Back here at Historic Horlick Field, Bob Brainerd, Gary Ellerson, our entire outstanding Time Warner Cable broadcast crew. 14-9 our score, the Raiders over the Bulldogs as we get set to start the second half. Some first half numbers, Gary. The total yards are about even. Racine 165 to 143, but how they got them really telling on the football game. On the ground, the Raiders piling up 106 yards, most of them by Brian Jennings. Mm-hmm. And only 12 yards rushing in 7 attempts by the Bulldogs. The other big number that really sticks out on the halftime stat sheet, 9 penalties for the Bulldogs, losing 78 yards. Too many yellow hankies as we're underway with the kickoff of the second half. Fielded by Andre Dry, who gets it out just to about the 40-yard line. So good field position to start the second half by the Bulldogs.
Yeah, once again, the Bulldogs come out and seem to be no quitting these guys. I mean, they come out right away, get good field position, and these guys, are what we heard, did not allow an opponent to score over 14 points at all last year.
Yeah, for the entire season when they were playing at that, the so-called double-A level of football. So that's why a move up to this level in the North American Football League, while it is a jump, it's not like a big scary proposition for the Bulldogs and any of the players who played with them last year, because they're used to winning. And as Gary mentioned, the shutout numbers were heavily tilted.
Much better job.
Wrapping up Michael Harrell that time. He tried to string it out, but all maroon jerseys right along there for the ride on first down.
Yeah, Nate Harris did a good job of stringing that thing out, staying home. Made a great tackle. Read it. Get outside. Fight him off. Pull him down. Good job, Nate Harris. Not let that guy get outside there.
Chad Svensson from Union Grove High School, just down the road. The big defensive lineman initially in there to slow things down. Pickup of 2 after all that. It's second down and 8 from the 43. Budzutski, the give. Dry gets the call. And good. 5 yards short of the first down. It'll be third down and 5 at about the 8.
You know, I saw big Wilbur Kennedy there for a minute, jump through the line of scrimmage, try to drag him down, but just couldn't quite get there. They allowed Andre Dry to get outside. Still good play by the Racing Raiders to stay home. Good tackle by Jamie Isom there. We got about 3rd and 2 here.
Yeah, 2 or 3 yards to go from the 48. They got to get it just beyond the field to the Bulldogs to keep their drive moving. Trailing 14-9 to begin the third quarter.
Oh, my.
Right over the middle. Santonio Laster trying to take it to the house.
He's rumbling, stumbling,
but not bumbling into the end zone, but close enough. Finally hauled down by Brian Sivas.
What you saw?
Brian Silvis, rather. Saved a touchdown, but not until
what you
the
saw
big
there.
Man went took this one almost all the way in for a touchdown.
Yeah, they were in an all-out blitz there, and somebody has that tight end man-to-man, and they just kind of let him go. I mean, that's just fundamental football there. If you're in an all-out blitz, you still got to have that tight end man-to-man. And they just kind of let him get out the line of scrimmage. I would assume that the linebacker probably had that tight end man-to-man and then peek at him.
And then once you get in the secondary, as you mentioned, Gary, that's pretty tough to haul down those big bodies.
He's a big man.
They mark it at the 2-yard line, first and goal from the 2 for the Bulldogs, threatening to regain the lead here to begin the third quarter. Not on that play. Nate Harris right in. Might have even lost a yard on the give to Tim Booth.
Good play by Nate Harris at getting good penetration. Offensive line, you got Big Kennedy up the middle there. They didn't run too much up in the middle on him.
Yeah, Wilbert goes 6 foot, 360.
Yeah, 360, baby. 2 pancakes short of 400.
Another way to look at it?
Yeah.
courtesy of Gary Ellerson.
Yeah.
Second and goal from the two. No gain in the play by Wisconsin.
Nice, nice play.
And they'll get no gain and lose yardage this time. Michael Harrell that time stopped in the backfield. Again, those big bods up front. Penetrating, getting it done.
Well, you had Darrell Overstreet there. He's out. He's a strong safety on your left side over. He stays home, makes a great play and stayed home, and they penetration out there.
Loss of two. So the Bulldogs on the big play over the middle got it down to the 2 yard line, but have been going backwards ever since. Well, now it's third and goal.
Well, they have not been able to run the football all night long. They've been getting most of their yards through the air. Let's just see if they throw the ball here.
Calvin Thomas at the bottom of the screen, Burns at the top, both of them weapons. He goes to Thomas in the corner, jump ball, who wins?
Touchdown.
Thomas, touchdown. Well, it was mano a mano.
Ty goes to receive every time, Bob.
One on one, Jerome Crawford down there, giving it all he could to make that play defensively, but the winner was Calvin Thomas.
Nope, no play action fake, just a one-step drop, throws it up in the air, and who can catch it? That's still pretty good coverage by that cornerback there, number 19. He was all over it.
Yeah, Crawford.
Jerome Crawford.
Yeah, you get in that one-on-one situation, and he was wrestling for that pigskin. Yeah. I mean, he did all he could. But give credit to Thomas.
Calvin Thomas just out jumping for the football because he had inside position. Just couldn't make a play.
PAT, they've already missed one tonight because of a penalty. Not this time. Punch it through. And with 10:55 to play in the third quarter, it's the Bulldogs back on top, 16-14. Well, an impressive drive, Gary Ellerson, by the Bulldogs to come. As you mentioned, trouble running the football. When they put it in the air, good things happened tonight.
Well, you know, they had great field position to begin with, and then, you know, all of a sudden they get, you know, they're in an all-out blitz situation. They, you know, the Racine Raiders are just breaking down fundamentally. I mean, you've got on that blitz they had down there. Somebody's got to have that tight end man-to-man, and then you let free in the secondary, and he's about, you know, 250 pounds. Those 100 pounds, you know, cornerback and safety are not going to bring that big guy down.
Doesn't matter how many takes you eat, you don't catch up.
No. They just bounce off.
Quit hitting me. You may have had seven surgeries, but
you can
still bring it. No. I'm afraid of all football players. That's, I told you. That's why I'm up here in the booth.
Yeah.
I respect the guys who strap it on every night.
You need to eat some more pancakes. That's what you need.
That's,
to do. You're too thin.
I work in this caramel corn up here.
Yeah, you got to put some butter on your pancakes.
Here's the boot. D'Elia back will field it at the 10. Blockers in front.
Reverse.
And then he it off.
Reverse.
To Kevin Barrett. And look at Barrett flying on the sidelines. Inside Bulldog territory. Knocked out of bounds by the kicker at the 45. Great special teams play by the Racine Raiders to set up shop in good field position.
No trickery by the Racine Raiders to start off their second half. You're going to see that they're going to get into the wedge, get bunched up. Verse, and there he comes out the left side.
Boy, and I didn't think D'Elia would give it up because he's carrying the football in his left hand and then just waited for Barrett to come across, switched the football in front of himself, and just dumped it off. But the exchange was flawless.
Yeah.
And the pickup, outstanding. Barrett sailing. All he had to do was beat the kicker, Borchert. Well, the kicker's been in on a couple tackles
yes,
tonight.
Yes. Let's see if the Raiders go back to their old grinded out style.
It worked for over 100 yards rushing in the first half. Flags fly. I think there were 12 men on the field for the Bulldogs.
You think that's why they got that play like that? They had too many guys out there?
Well, it helps if you got an extra guy.
Count them up, ref.
It's also called cheating.
Yeah, well. You're at Historic Horlick Field, you know.
Well aware. Maybe while all the penalties are going on, we should rattle off some of the reasons they call this Historic Horlick Football Field, because a lot has happened here over the years. In fact, the Racine Peaches, them in the league of their own,
yeah.
the
The girls,
the gals playing baseball? Yeah, they played over here, too.
Where did they play at?
Right here at Historic Horlick Field.
Right here?
The whole complex is,
well,
yeah.
Well, a big complex.
Well, they had a baseball diamond here, too.
Well, the peaches, the baseball diamond's right in back of us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Any peaches out there now?
No, I think the gals have hung it up.
Okay.
Yeah. They're all in the Hall of Fame, and... And you saw some of the flags flying there, some of the retired numbers and championships, some of the seven national championships won by Racine teams over the years.
Okay.
Two fakes by Novotny. Fire over the middle, complete.
Nice play.
To Ryan Brugioni, the 5'11 wide receiver out of Northern Michigan. They hook up for the first time tonight. First and 10, Racine.
Yeah, the first time you didn't see Novotny really running for his life. He faked the reverse to the alley and stands tall in the pocket and makes a perfect strike throw across the middle here. Look at that. He's got all day to throw the ball, all day to throw it.
Yeah, he faked to Jennings, then faked to D'Elia.
Mm-hmm.
And that allowed the Bulldogs, who were biting on both fakes, allowed number one to spring himself free. First and 10 at the 22. Getting close to the red zone are the Raiders, trying to regain the lead here after giving it up to begin the third quarter. A busted play that still picks up some yardage down to the 15-yard line. I didn't see who got the carry. There it is.
Fullback.
Josh McCara out of the pile.
And I think what it is, you just had a straight dive play. Nothing fancy about that. They just want to grind. Now the Racine Raiders have been having trouble here in this game. When they get to the 20 and in, they just seem to stall out. Let's see if they win at halftime and try to figure this thing out and try to get some points on the board once they get 20 and in.
Second and three from the 22. Novotny with a pair behind him in the backfield. And twin receivers is right. He'll go to them. Complete. Down to the 10, should be a first down as DeAndre Hatch hauls it in.
Nice pitch and catch there by Novotny and Hatch. Hatch just run a straight square out there for the first down. Great, great square out there by Hatch. Good catch, good pitch and catch there.
They'll spot the ball at the 11-yard line.
Novotny seemed to be a little bit more poised this time than he were in the second half.
Still pick up a first down without scoring a touchdown. First and 10 at the 11 for the Raiders. Hatch at the bottom of the screen and Palmer at the top. But the give is to Jennings, who is met by about half of that Bulldog defense. Nothing doing. Looks like no gain on the play. It'll be second down and 10.
That now, Bulldog defense is a bunch over there.
Now, when they get down in this territory, Gary Ellerson, you were talking with head coach Kopak, and he said that while the plays are scripted, once they get into this area of the football field, it's all on Dan Novotny, isn't it?
Yeah, Novotny's calling on the plays. Maybe he should take it back from him, though. I'm not sure. Hadn't been working too well in the short yard.
You're not giving a chance here, are you?
Is he an Oshkosh guy?
Well, yes. No, he's from Herbert's. The other QB is from Oshkosh. Jennings, a little quick burst, gets it to about the 7-yard line, so it'll be about third down and 6 to get the first down.
Okay, now they bring him over to the sideline. They're going to give him the play this time. Bob.
Yeah, he's supposed to call the plays himself by going up there and reading that defense and taking whatever the defense gives him.
All right, what we got here? Third down. Here we go.
Third and 9 from the 10. Again, they can get the first, get it to the 1-yard line.
Yeah, they got a huge mismatch down here with number 85 down on the left-hand side. They just want to lob it up.
Yeah, Hatch on Antoine Vance. We'll see what happens.
Give it to him.
And he goes the other way. Looking for an opening. Fires.
Throws it away.
Yeah, threw it to the concession stand. Intended over there for Sam D'Elia. But a whole bunch of jerseys with green pants in the vicinity. It'll be fourth down. So your mismatch at the other end of the field, Gary Ellerson, Novotny had Hatch the other way, one-on-one, but decided to go with the numbers on the right side.
To the strong side, but you got this big number 85 down here. DeAndre Hatch, and in the cornerback number, I believe it's number six, Joel Dupras. I'm sorry, that's the kicker.
Dominic Ross down at the bottom, there. Yeah. And Antoine Vance on there, too.
Take that out every time.
This is Dupras, and it's blocked.
And their red zone woes continue.
Yeah, drive negated and then some, and big victory that time for the Wisconsin Bulldogs, who had the kickoff returned into their own territory, and then the march down the field into the 10-yard line, but it's snuffed out on the blocked field goal. We'll be back with more football for the team. Wisconsin Bulldog football, first and 10 at the 10. And the pitch.
Woo!
Andre Dry pays the price.
That's my man Jamie Isom bringing the load. I talked to him before the game. I said, Jamie, you going to bring it today, baby? He said, don't you know it? Don't you know it? That's the way you stay home. Them linebackers now, you see, Bob, they're staying home. They're getting contained. They're stretching that thing out. And that is the way it should be played, Bob.
Now, are you going to take credit for that play because you had this pregame chat with Jamie? Are you going to give yourself a pat on the back?
Yeah, Jamie's my guy.
All right.
We go way back.
Yeah.
We go way back.
Loss of two. Second and 12 from the 8. And this is where the Raider defense needs to get stout and get this football. Quick flip to Burns, and watch out the speed.
Bye-bye.
He's gone.
Bye-bye.
92-yard touchdown as he flashes the pigskin.
Should be a penalty on
going in.
Bye-bye.
My goodness. Well, we warned you at the top of the show. Antoine Burns, who played football at Minnesota and had stints throughout the National Football League, turned on the Jets.
Mm-mm. Just a quick slant route that you get here. And, you know, once again, no safety over the top. Bye-bye. Nothing exciting about that. I mean, that's a fundamental play that you learn when you're in sixth grade. Quick slant to the house.
And when you quick slant with number 18.
If he catches it, nobody's in the middle?
Yep.
Katie by the door.
You're asking, who's Katie, by the way?
Katie by the door.
I've heard the expression, but I don't know who.
She's on the other side of the door.
Oh, she's on the other side.
Yes,
okay. Extra point. Pending here for the Bulldogs, and I say pending because of that, another flag. They lead it 22-14, and again a procedure call. The last time they had this called on them, they didn't produce the PAT, but the lead is 8 currently for the Bulldogs on an electrifying 92-yard hookup between Mike Budzutski, he's from Oshkosh, and Antoine Burns, who did all the rest.
You love to call them Oshkosh guys, don't you? I tried to give you the other guy from the Raiders. You weren't biting on that one.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, block.
Now this one's blocked.
All right.
And so the penalties on the PATs have twice cost the Bulldogs a couple of points tonight. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. But right now, nothing haunting Wisconsin. They lead it 22-14. The big play right here, Antoine Burns burning the secondary. Well, the Wisconsin Bulldogs, after stopping that Racine Raider drive by blocking the field goal, didn't waste any time. Seconds later, first play, that 92-yard hookup to Antoine Burns really turns the whole feel of this game around. It's 22-14 now. And we'll see what the Raiders are made of. This is one of those.
Is this gut check time?
Yeah, it's gut check time. Exactly. I was just going to say that.
If it's not, it's sure getting pretty doggone close to it. I mean, in this game, you feel like that the Raiders just cannot stop the Bulldogs' passing offense.
D'Elia.
He wants to ladder it.
Yeah.
Stayed home. Not happening.
He lateraled the forward pass backwards to Zachariah Antoine. Played football at Waukegan East High School just across the border. And I don't know about you, Gary Ellerson, but that little risky on that play.
That was very risky. Probably should have kept that one. But nevertheless, it worked out. And then let's just see what the Raiders can do. Can they come down and get a sustained drive and march it down the field.
See D'Elia playing quarterback.
No quarterback, but stay home here. Number 28, that is Reggie Lawrence, Reggie. Running back out of Whitewater, stayed home, contained. I'm impressed with these Wisconsin Bulldogs. They seem to be fundamentally sound, Bob.
Playing well tonight.
You notice I haven't called you Cliff yet.
Thank you for that, by the way.
You're welcome.
I know Cliff, and I'd have to belt you if you did call me Cliff. First and 10 at the 16. Hatch on the flip. Going to try to make something out of this. He does. Gets it out to the 29-yard line. Picks up the first down.
They need to get the ball to Hatch a little bit more. I think he's a very gifted receiver that they need to try to feature him a little bit more in his offense. He's got pretty good skills. They just run a quick hitch here out to Hatch. Just a little quick hitch just to give him the ball, see if they can get him going here.
And you can see D'Elia in the neighborhood as well. He of the two touchdowns tonight, so they have to keep an eye on number three. And that perhaps allowed Hatch some breathing room to make that catch. First and 10 at the 28. As we wind down in the third quarter.
Give it to him again, same play.
Well, they're listening to Gary Ellerson. Again, they're just throwing the quick sideline hitch to Hatch and letting him take that frame and take those wheels and moving on out. Another first down out to the 40.
Yeah, same play again. Now, you know what they're trying to do is suck the defense up a little bit and see if they can get Hatch deep here. Let's see if for the Bulldogs suck up on this and we can get him beat deep here. We can get one past him.
And Brian Jennings, who was the big star offensively on the ground, not even in the backfield. So the Raiders.
They faked it to him. There he is.
Going to the air, and there's a completion over the middle to the 42. Again, Ryan Brugioni with the big hookup. Dan Novotny looking one way, firing over the middle, finding number one for another first down.
The Raiders are in a little bit of a hurry-up offense. We call it kind of a sugar offense where it's kind of a little sweet but not too tart. And they just kind of hurry up just a little bit. They're taking their time, trying to get the tempo up a little bit.
Yeah, not a panic hurry-up offense by any means, but again, just to change the tempo up. Jennings not even in the backfield. Novotny again fires it, juggled, reeled in. Dorian Palmer did a good job of keeping his eye on the football and not letting it slip through the fingertips. He makes the catch, keeps his drive moving.
This is a great catch by Palmer here. I mean, he went up and got that ball. And he's all of 6'4". And they got two receivers. They got Palmer and Hatch. They got Palmer at about 6'4". They got Hatch at about 6'3". I mean, let's work into those guys a little bit and see if they can make some things happen for us. Got time out here?
Indeed we do. So the Raiders, who go to that sweet offensive
sugar
game plan. Sugar, I'm sorry.
With sugar.
Well, that's what you call it. I don't know what
huddle.
They call it. They have their own version,
I'm sure.
They
may call it sweet.
They may.
But I call it sugar. There's another look at this play here. What they ran before this, they ran a couple of hitches to the left over here. Now they decide to come back over here to Dorian Palmer and makes a great catch going up and getting the ball. Like I say, he's all 6'4", 6'5". Way to haul that thing in, Dorian.
How are you out of the backfield catching passes?
Oh, I was a wide receiver in high school.
In high school?
Yeah.
I'm talking college. I'm talking, the big time.
Yeah,
at
so
Wisconsin
then,
and Green Bay.
Well, then in college, I was able to split out like a receiver and be a running back because I could do a little bit of both. I was Sterling Sharp before Sterling Sharp was Sterling Sharp.
Oh, does Sterling know that?
Yeah, he know that.
All right.
We're from Georgia. He's from Georgia, too.
Second and three, pickup of seven on that little juggling act. Again to the air, Novotny down the sideline.
Like I said to you, Bob, they got these big receivers. Let's throw it up and get those boys the ball right now.
Dorian Palmer that time, the big receiver on the reception. Inside the five, first and goal Racine.
Dorian, you got to shake that off. They look off to the left, over here to back. Great catch. Great. They can do this all day if they want to. I mean, these guys, you got these guys 6'4 and 6'5 on side. You got to be able to get these ball to the outside. Now, don't bog down right here. You're in the red zone. They got to be able to put this thing in now.
First and goal at the three. Hatch remains in the shotgun. Scoops it, fires.
Drops it.
Intended there for Peter Brown.
Hit him in the bad spot.
Right in the numbers.
Yeah.
Yep. Right in that number 8.
And so, Now throw a fade route here to number 85.
You see Brown turning and spinning and recovering to face Novotny. And as you said, just hit him in a bad spot. So it's second and goal from the three.
So now you got a bunch formation here. Everybody's to your right.
And here's Jennings in the backfield for the first time on this drive, number 35. See if he gets the call with 3 yards to get it across the line. He does. Behind his blockers, may have got one.
May.
But did not cross the goal line, so it'll be third down and goal.
Big May.
Big May.
That's a big May. No, okay. We got Dorian coming back in the game now. Let's see if they can split these guys out and try something. Although Dorian seemed to be holding his wrist like he's hurt, but he's going to shake that off and go. A little bit of confusion on offense, seems like here.
Jennings still in the backfield on third down and goal from the 1 yard line. Novotny under center, trying to punch this one in for the Raiders. Long signals at the line. Jennings.
Nothing. Flag though.
Flags fly. He didn't get in anyway. We'll see what the penalty is. If it pushes the Raiders back, you got to shake your head and say, oh my.
Can't see what the flag was actually on. The Bulldogs are playing stout defense in the middle. The Raiders have had on, like I said repeatedly, all night long. They had trouble in the red zone against these Bulldogs. They just don't give up.
And then a mistake, a legal procedure, will push it back from the 1 yard line
to
back to the six. So Novotny will have to regroup the troops. And from a much more real estate to work with, go at it here on third down. Jennings, the lone back, bunched up three receivers to the right of Novotny. Fake to Jennings, the roll, fires into the end zone, nobody home, and picked off.
I think you got a holding here. They were holding one of the receivers, it appears to me.
Dominic,
the Bulldogs were holding one of the receivers, I believe.
Dominic Ross got the interception in the end zone, but you saw the flags fly. And if it is holding, that'll be first down and give new life to the Raiders. And that would be a huge break for a team that needs one on this drive.
And that they do, because they're going to need all four of these down to get it in, seems like. Holy moly.
You're a bit down on the red zone offense of the Raiders tonight.
Yeah, a bit. You just don't feel confident when they get down. I mean, they seem to do well between the 20s, but when they get inside the 20, they just seem to putter out a little bit.
You saw the call, as Gary called it as well. Holding called in the end zone. And so new life for the Raiders and a new set of downs, more importantly.
More importantly, you don't need all four of them to get in, Bob.
Now, come on.
Huh?
Come on, have confidence.
Well, I said they're going to need all four of them to get in. They still can get in.
I said they get right here. I'm going to go against the grain, go against you. First and goal from the three. Jennings in the backfield. Novotny under center. D'Elia and Palmer at the top. Novotny.
Botch play.
Yeah. He and Jennings not on the same page, and Novotny just tried to get back to the line of scrimmage. He might have lost a yard. So we're under a minute to go in the third quarter.
Botched handoff here.
Yeah, Jennings wasn't ready
for
it.
They were going the right way, but they just couldn't get the timing out.
Loss of one. Second and goal from the four. This is like birthing going on, trying to get this thing into the end zone. Just laboring.
All right, now we're going to spread it out. Let's see what we got. About time.
And then the gift to Jennings up the gut, touchdown. That's what you got to do. Spread it out. Get him thinking pass.
Yeah.
And then just dump it off to your workhorse that's been getting it done all night long.
And what you see, just a straight give handoff. It's sort of like a draw. But what you had, double twins. And I'm out a little bit. Nobody's in the middle. Good play, coach. They go for two.
And Dan Novotny did that Brett Favre thing that every QB does now, you know, that little fake after the fact. Yeah, they're going for two, trying to tie this thing up. Novotny.
Nice,
fires.
Nice. Oh.
Knocked away. Good defensive
good
play that time by Irv Crawford
good
to break up the two-point conversion.
Yes, sir.
So, and it keeps the lead with the Bulldogs. 22-20, final seconds of the third quarter coming your way when we come back. We're back at Historic Horlick Field, which could use a little more water, but so could my lawn.
Yeah. Been a little drought going on here.
Yeah, it's been dry throughout all of Wisconsin this summer.
I'm not complaining, though.
No, the weather's been fantastic, including tonight. Slight breeze blowing. It's cool. It's perfect conditions for football.
A nice crowd here tonight, though, Bob, out here in Racine. People came out and really supporting these teams that are out here tonight. Unbelievable.
And you can see on the other side of the football field, all the fans have filled in that portion of the bleachers. We're on the opposite side where the construction continues. And as the season progresses, they'll have both sides with fans aplenty. Antoine Vance on the return gets it out to the 25-yard line. That's where the Bulldogs will set up shop first and 10. So now the lead is just two for Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll run a play here and perhaps wind down the third quarter and then 15 minutes to decide things here in the regular season opener.
You think their pass defense is going to be tested here, Bob?
I would keep an eye open for number 18. That's all I'm going to say.
You think they're going to test the pass defense here, Bob?
I'm not down there chewing guys out or running things at all. But Antoine Burns, certainly a weapon to be reckoned with. He'll be at the bottom of the screen when you see the set here on first and 10 at the 24-yard line for the Bulldogs. Budzewski rolls, looks that way, and Burns comes back and nearly makes an acrobatic catch.
What you see now the Racine Raiders have done now, Bob, they seem like they've gone to more like a nickel package where now they have added an extra defensive back in the game, and then that has allowed them to really jump on these receivers now and be a little bit more aggressive on the defensive end.
I mean,
almost made a good catch on that one.
Burns, he came out of nowhere, came into your picture and just laid out and nearly came up with that football.
5 seconds to go right here in the third quarter.
If there isn't a penalty, it will be the last play of the third quarter. Been an entertaining football game to open the 2007 season for these rivals.
Reverse.
Double reverse. That's fumbled, but hauled in and gathered in by Rodney Ellison. Oh, my. That had disaster written all over it as the third quarter comes to a close. And the Bulldogs take a big, deep breath and hang on to the football. 22-20 our score after three. We come back with the pivotal fourth quarter from Historic Horlick Field on Time Warner Sports.
All right.
We are back and just in time to see the interception by Kevin Barrett. A third and 25 play. Than play it safe, the Bulldogs tried to get that first down. Now flags fly all over the football field in this play. So we'll see if the interception stands for Kevin Barrett.
Got it stand. And what you've seen here, Bob, I think the Racine Raiders have made an adjustment now. They have gone through a nickel package on defense, which they have now added another defensive back into the defense. And then this is allowing now the Racine Raiders to get more, well, actually have more guys in the secondary, and they can roam around a little bit and get these passes that he's been trying throwing up all game long.
Intended there for Donald Woods, and you could see clearly Barrett coming across, jumping right in front to make that interception.
Like you got a personal foul against the Bulldogs, maybe a face mask doing it, Bob.
So the interception stands, and tack on 15 more, and Racine keeps the football, and they're in great shape. They have it at the Wisconsin 24-yard line.
Now, Bob, look down here. You got number 81 down here, Bob. all alone against number six down here of the
Yeah, that's
Bulldogs.
Ross and Palmer again. You've been begging for the to
I've
see something
begging,
happen
oh,
here.
Again, just throw the fade to the outside. He can't cover this kid.
Coach Ellerson wants to see that play instead.
Got a counter.
The counter and the give to Jennings. Picks up a couple. It'll be second and eight. Now we've seen some explosiveness and some big plays on both sides of the football from both of these ball clubs.
Mm-hmm.
And the touchdowns in the first half, those two gentlemen, 3 and 15, D'Elia and Novotny.
They have hooked up twice.
We'll see if
they
do it again.
The backfield.
And it's been in this area of the football field that both those touchdowns came.
I wouldn't be surprised if they do a toss pass and D'Elia throwing the ball here, Bob.
It's in the backfield. So keep an eye on number three, second and eight from the 22. The blitz, D'Elia.
Reverse
to Palmer.
Come on, Palmer.
Palmer needs a block. Doesn't get it. Good play by Mike Seward over there, number 37, to stop Palmer at the 20-yard line. And we've got an injured for the Bulldogs. Robert Taylor lost his cap and is slow to get up.
They set this up pretty good. Got a reverse here. I would love to see Palmer use his block to the outside and try to get outside. He's got good speed. His kid is the sideline, but instead he decides to take it up. You can always second guess him, but you know, you never know what you're gonna do when you're running the football there. So, but
yeah, second guessing, that's your job.
Yeah, that's what we do. I'm chair quarterback here, Bob.
Robert Taylor. You see him going off kind of on his own power. He was at the end of that play and kind of rolled over Palmer at the end of the play and lost his helmet and perhaps lost his wind on the so he'll go to the sidelines, get some medical attention. In the meantime, big play on third down and six from the 20. They're gonna split Palmer and D'Elia to the right side. Two more receivers at the top.
Got double twins here.
So Novotny, plenty to work with via the air. And again, here comes
inside
the blitz.
Give.
The big fullback, Makara, gets the call. Going to be short of the first down by about 2 yards. So
you got to kick a field goal.
Fourth down and two. And with 13 and change to go in the fourth quarter. Yeah, the field goal, that's the ball here.
Yeah, you got to kick a field goal here.
Chance to regain the lead here in the fourth quarter. In a back-and-forth contest between the Bulldogs and Raiders. That man making the decision to go for three, Joel Dupras, on to attempt a 34-yard field goal.
Last one was blocked, Bob. Let's see what he does this time.
Eric Feast on the hold. That one a line drive. We mentioned that Joel is a converted soccer player, and that would have been a good kick in soccer.
Yeah, that may have been a good kick in soccer, Bob. That's not going to work in football. Yeah, you can tackle, but he can't kick. I buy that. I buy that for a dollar.
So Joel, frustrated with that effort.
Yeah, he's not happy about that. Coach not happy either. Bob, once again, what happens? They drive the football all down
mm-hmm.
here. Then there you go.
And Eric Tudis.
Well, actually,
happy with the end result
right
there because
actually,
these guys
defense.
Keep the lead.
Yeah, actually, defense comes up with a big pick and then they get nothing out of it. So, wasted opportunity for the Racine Raiders to actually put it away a little bit.
Yeah, problem thwarted again by the Bulldogs who dodge that bullet, keep the lead at 22-20. First and 10 from the 24.
Now, what the Bulldogs probably should do now, Bob, is start running the football because now number 20 now in the game, he's your extra defensive back. He's not really playing the run, so now you have one less guy to be on the line of scrimmage to stop the run. But we know that the Bulldogs probably won't stop doing what they're doing, and that is throwing the football. They've been throwing it all day.
Perhaps they try and run it here and try and get the Raiders thinking run and then go back to the pass.
Yeah, number 20 would be Dale Overstreet down. And he looks like he's a linebacker, but he's really another defensive back.
Second down and eight from the 26.
That's what I'd be doing right there.
Keep it in the ground. Nearly a mask. But Andre Dry gets it out and gets it close to a first down. Going to be third down and about a yard to go to move the chains. So the running attack hasn't been that impressive for the Bulldogs, but if they can piece together a couple first downs here and chew up some of this clock and put the offense back into striking to go back to the air, maybe a huge drive for the Bulldogs. Big play here, though, third down and one. They keep it on the ground. And a bad decision because the defense of the Raiders right there, Jamie Isom, Gary's new man right there for the stuff.
And what you saw now, you know, started playing a game with them. Now they took the extra defensive back out. They loaded line scrimmage. That's a pretty good job at coordinating there. And you got Big Isom there. He's coming in, you know, nobody touched him. Untouched to make a play. Good job.
Chad Svensson right on top to make sure. Loss of three on that play. Fourth down, punting unit on for the Bulldogs. Joe Zukas back there to boot this one away. Deep for the Raiders. Kevin Barrett, he's dangerous. He's been dangerous tonight. Just gets that one off. Barrett fields at the 33. Slips one tackle, gets around his own man, slips another tackle, and then finally dragged down at the 38. That's where the Raiders will bring their offense onto the field. They trail it by two, 22-20. You're watching North American Football League action on Time Warner Sports. First and 10 from the 38, Dan Novotny back to work. Fake to Palmer. Now he waves him downfield and Novotny.
No.
Are they gonna call grounding on that? He was out of the pocket. And that is the call. So right. Novotny heads up that time, had nobody to throw it to. And again, didn't have to eat the football once he got out of the pocket. He tossed it at the sidelines and result incomplete.
Well, they tried to run the same play again over here to Palmer, and it just didn't work out. And he had double twins. Last time they ran the formation, double twin formation, they gave it to Jennings up the middle. Let's see if they spread him out and try to get it to Jennings up the middle here.
Second down and 10 from the 38. Craig Deke was giving chase that time. Big number 60 in Novotny's grill. Again, the pump fake, and then the Palmer complete in the Bulldogs' territory. Novotny to Palmer. First down, Raiders. And one of the Bulldogs, the football.
Doesn't matter.
It's Antoine Burns.
He's already down.
They will whistle it dead.
Yeah.
Take another look. Novotny.
Well, they try to run quick slant inside here to Palmer. Didn't work out. Pump fake, and he just took off and ran up the field. They can't cover this guy. I mean, they try to feed him the ball a little bit more if I was them.
And you saw Burns there trying to wrestle that football, but clearly down on the ground. First and 10 from the 36. Novotny in the shotgun.
Yes.
To D'Elia again. Oh!
How does this guy get behind him all the time?
Speed, Gary, speed. D'Elia's got it.
Ooh.
Nearly got his third TD hookup of the night.
Ooh. I'm gonna start calling Dominique Rose Toast. Nickname gonna be Toast.
You're tough on the guys, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
They not only get paid, they gotta take abuse
yes,
from you.
Yes, sir.
It's a tough night.
To be who?
To be these guys.
All right, here we go.
Who's that Gary Ellerson telling me? Second down and 10 from the 36. D'Elia again at the bottom of the screen. He's got to be gassed. They give everybody a breather, and Jennings gets lassoed, corralled, and thrown backwards by Troy Dyzak.
Yes, sir. Get hogtied here. You hate when guys get neck, though. You don't want guys up around your neck. You can get away. You don't want that.
What does that feel like, Gary, when you ball, you take a few steps and get hogtied?
That doesn't feel good. You want me to try it on you one time?
No. No, I'm asking you, the former running back, how does it feel? Demonstration. Just tell the viewers out there how it feels.
Doesn't feel good, Bob.
There you go. No need for visuals beyond that. Third and 10 from the 36. Raiders
Uh-oh, not a good snap.
Bad snap. Novotny recovers, though. Quick fire and complete for a first down.
Nice throw.
DeAndre Hatch right there to make the catch, and the drive stays alive. Novotny, give him scooping that foot.
You got to give Jennings credit, too. Man. He made a great block on Darius Jones there on the outside to keep that thing going and get good protection.
Hatch didn't try to get too fancy. He went to his knees, made sure he got that football reeled in, had enough for the first down. First and 10 at the 25. Raiders offense on the move again, trailing at 22-20. We're under 8 to play in the ball game. Novotny tipped at the line.
We're trying to get it to him.
It's incomplete. Yeah, they're going for Palmer again.
Trying to get it to him.
Or going to Hatch, your pardon.
Now that was Palmer. Palmer's 81, right? Who's 81? Palmer.
Palmer's 81. Again, the snap. That's not helping the cause here. And then tipped at the line. I didn't catch the number there. And that really ended all hopes of that play leading, so it's second down and 10 from the 25.
All right, we got Palmer down the bottom and Hatch up to the top. Where's that number three kid at that?
He's on the inside.
There he is.
From the shotgun again.
Oh, screen. Oh, nice play.
Yeah, dump off to Jennings. He squirts his way inside the 20. He'll be about 3 yards shy of the first. Third down and three coming up for the Raiders.
Nice little play there. I like that. You got everybody coming to your right side. I mean, he even looks right. Good job by the quarterback. He just dumps it off here to Jennings. I like Jennings. Is a nice little running back. I like him. He does a little bit of everything. He can block, he can run, he can catch. Good kid to have.
Third down and two. They spotted at the 18. Field goal probably out of the question here.
No, you probably don't want to go for the field goal, buddy. There he is. Get upfield. Now get upfield.
Complete to Palmer.
Short.
And football?
Yeah, DP, get up. Yeah, DP.
Still no indication. He hangs on. Is it enough for the first down? I don't think so.
Yeah, they kind of ran backwards here a little bit.
Well, he lost that football.
Yeah, they kind of bent DP backwards. That's what they call him, DP. They kind of ran backwards there a little bit. It's going to be fourth down, Bob. They're going to have to go for this.
Yeah, fourth down. Out to sort things out and get this play right. It's crucial. 7:12 to go, and the Raiders trail it by two. Fourth and two coming up when we come back. So here we are, fourth and two to go for the Raiders. Ball spotted at the 16. They need to get just the 15-yard line. So
All right.
2 yards or so. It's in the vicinity of 2 yards.
See what we get here, Bob.
But regardless, after that last field goal attempt, not even a question of whether they're going for it or not.
They have to. All right.
Hatch and Brugioni at the top of the screen. D'Elia at the bottom of the screen, along with Brown on fourth and two. Jennings in the backfield.
Draw him outside.
And if they did, it's a free five and a first down. But did one of the linemen flinch?
No, they drew him outside.
Raider fans say no. The officials say no as well. First down, Racine. That's an easy first down when nobody has to do anything.
Hey.
Except Novotny. He did a good job of trying to bark him off the line. Change the cadence a little bit.
Get him any way you can down there, Bob.
Yeah.
Good job, guys. Way to hold your water.
So first and 10 from the 11. So again, they can get the first down without scoring, but I'd like to score. Not worry about it. Fresh set of downs for the Raiders. Jennings the lone back behind Novotny. D'Elia in motion.
Gotta watch D'Elia.
And three gets the call. Nearly wrapped, but D'Elia shakes him and gets back to the original line of scrimmage. So all that and no gain for Sam D'Elia.
Lost a yard on that play. You gotta know when he's in the game, he's gonna, you know, when he's gonna do something. If he goes in motion, they're going to give him the ball. 9 times out of 10. Did a good job of getting back to the line of scrimmage.
And really, Gary, give Irv Crawford credit because he didn't make the initial tackle, but he slowed up the lead. No gain on the play. Second down and 10. Still at the 11-yard line. Novotny's going to go shotgun again. A pair of receivers on each side. Jennings standing toe-to-toe with his quarterback. And he takes the direct snap. Yep. But it only nets a yard on the play. So third down and 9 coming up for the Raiders.
Dorian Palmer's back in. I don't know what that means, but I might want to watch for him.
I'll keep my eye. Yeah, he's been.
Or DeLeer's a guy. He's been down here twice.
You like to get number 3 involved just because not only the 2 TDs tonight, but just that speed.
Yeah.
A lot of options there with 3, but we will see what happens on third down and 9 from the 10-yard line. Trailing by 2. Novotny under center. Wants to go to the corner.
Like I said, Dorian Palmer is back in the game.
10-yard hookup. Novotny to Palmer. And the Racine Raiders regain the lead 26-22. Good job by the QB that time to just wait for Palmer to spring free and then patiently throw that pass.
That he did. I mean, he could have. I mean, it didn't look smooth, but he pump faked a couple times.
And now an important PAT coming up. Joel Dupras.
Did he get it?
Boy, he just got it. That ball deflected, but it still somehow willed its way over the crossbar. The touchdown one more time to get Racine the lead.
Way to go up in there and get it by Dorian Palmer. That was a good catch by him.
And Novotny, good job on his end.
Yes, sir.
To wait for receiver to spring open, throw it up and over those big paws on the defensive line. End result, touchdown.
Yeah.
Scoreboard, 27-22. Raiders over the Bulldogs with 5:34 to play. And then the
little celebration.
Celebration with his teammate, DeAndre Hatch. It's first, they got that down, don't they?
Yeah, I think they got that down. They worked on that a little bit at the house.
Well, you practice twice a week, but celebrations you can practice
you can
all week. Yeah, you can do it in the house.
You can do that at the house.
You can do it on the internet if you like.
That's what we used to. We used to do it at the house, do it at the apartment, hang out, make up stuff, choreograph it, you know. Kind of like what you and I do, Bob.
Well, this is hardly choreographed.
We choreographed this stuff.
We're just flying by the seat of our pants, Gary. You know that. We just wing it. We just let these guys provide the entertainment, and we're just trying to catch up and keep up. Good ball game here in the regular season opener. 27-22, and the Bulldogs facing a 5-point deficit. They'll have to march down the field to regain the lead. They'll need a TD to do it. The boot at the 3 is Dominic Ross. Brings it out to the 20, tries to reverse field.
Fumble.
Lost the football. Who's got it? Raiders say they have it.
Yes.
And that'll make this uphill battle even more treacherous for the Bulldogs, trailing by 5 and turning the football back over to the Raiders.
Kyle Perfetto comes out with that football, Bob. I mean, you know, you look like Dominique Ross out here with the football, and he's kind of got it tucked away, but those guys kind of went after it a little bit and kind of stripped it away from him.
Trying to fight for extra yards was Ross, and he paid the price.
Let's see if they can put the ball game away here now.
Coughed it up to the offense again. First and 10 at the 19. Novotny to give.
I tell you what, Bob. I tell you what.
Tell me.
That was a heck of a block just then by DeMarcus Francis. Unbelievable. No, I'm sorry. That was Jennings that made that block.
That's your do it all back.
That's him that made that block. Bone crusher.
And you saw 35 celebrate. Woo! He knew he threw that block.
Oh yeah, I felt it up here. And they got him. Got him at fullback. That kid, he's a great back. That kid does it all. They got him at fullback. They got Jennings at fullback right now.
DeMarcus Francis on the carry. 2 second down and 8 from the 17. And the give to number 13, Jamal Cannon. Cannon played at Wisconsin Lacrosse, the Eagles. And the clock continues to wind down here in the fourth quarter.
A lot of time left, Bob. The way these boys been throwing the ball all night long now, I mean, Wisconsin Bulldogs, they're going to have to get that clock down a lot quicker than that.
Yeah, that's always the danger. They're still going to get a chance to run Burns and company out there.
Yes, sir.
At least one more time.
Because they got a kid that can take it all the way to the house.
And has tonight.
Yes.
Third down and 7 from the 16-yard line. Timeout called by the Raiders. We will keep it right here.
What a great game, huh?
Yeah.
What a great game. We got over 1,000 people here tonight, buddy, in the stands. You got people lined up all the way around the fence here tonight, buddy.
And we talked about the long tradition and the history of football down here in Racine. And this is something that fans turn out for. We got to the ballpark a couple hours before it came.
Right.
There were already people in the parking lot tailgating, ready to go, ready for the season to start.
You know, this is a good hometown feel to it around here, these Racine Raiders.
And the Wisconsin Bulldogs, as you mentioned, switching leagues to the North American Football League and in the same division now as the Racine Raiders. So they'll see each other one more time during the summer. Nice little rivalry already building here. On opening night.
I would say so.
Bulldogs here, and for Racine, 3rd and 7.
Yeah, I think you keep it on the ground here if you can. You may even go for it on 4th down and keep it on the ground if you have to.
They've got number 88, Lowell Schopfeld, the big tight end who played at Stout in the backfield. Kind of that elephant backfield, if you will.
Counter, inside counter.
And Novotny keeps it all the way. Gets a block from D'Elia.
What a great play. They faked the counter to the left of Jennings. And Novotny came out on the right side on that play.
And
what
then
a good-looking play.
And then once he gets down close to the goal line, watch D'Elia with the blocks. Oh, he even faked our cameraman.
I was fooled. I thought Jennings had the ball.
And Novotny had it all the way. And there you see the end result.
Yes, sir.
What you didn't see was D'Elia down there in the corner fending off those defensive backs, allowing Novotny to pick up 4 yards. First and goal from the 1. A touchdown here would ice it. Blown up at the line. Loss on the play. Right there, Troy Dyzak, 51. Throwing down DeMarcus Francis for a loss of 3.
Troy Dyzak out of Lakeland College, and he just shot the gap, and there's nobody there. And nobody even touched him. You got to be careful here that you put the football down. Make sure everybody get that thing tight to tight, toe to toe for the Raiders. Don't let anybody through, and no fumbles.
Second and goal from the 3. Jennings back in there, the lone back. Everybody bunched up at the line. They'll go to the air.
Play action. That's not bad.
Now Novotny had to throw it at the feet intended for D'Elia. Well covered, though. And it'll be 3rd and goal from the 3.
I'd rather have that than the alternative going back the other way.
And Novotny knew that. We've seen the smarts of this veteran QB. Many times these guys making the heads-up plays when they're in trouble. They don't try to force things and get creative, if you will. Break for the Bulldogs. It stopped the clock at 2:21.
Well, you know what? I'd run the football again, but like I say, guess who's in the game? Number 81.
Palmer at the bottom, Hatch at the top. 3rd and goal from the 3.
There we go.
Jennings trying to
touchdown.
Touchdown, Racine Raiders. And that caps it off on a big night on the ground by the 5'9", 210-pound Brian Jennings.
Yeah, that kid's unbelievable. What a work. He does it all. He does it all. Just a straight handoff. Cuts it to the outside. He did most of that by himself, Bob. I mean, the offensive lineman got some push, but I mean, the play was designed to go inside. Jennings saw something to the outside to his left and broke it out there and got into the end zone.
Joel DeProw, the extra point on the way.
He's kicking that
and it is good, yeah.
Is it good?
It is good.
All right.
And the scoreboard is good for the hometown fans. 34-22. Raiders lead it by 12. One more look at the touchdown that may have iced the victory for the Racine Raiders on opening night.
Watch for some trickery here on this kickoff return here, Bob. Everybody guys stay home.
So the lead is 12.
I'm sure the special team coach said, hey guys, all right, watch for some trickery. Run down the field. Stay in your lanes. Don't get beat outside.
And what you want to prevent here, whether it's on the kickoff or once the offense get their hands on the football, is prevent the big play.
Thank you.
33-22 our score. Bulldogs will have to score and score in a hurry and then do the old onside kick to get the football back again. We'll see if there is any trickery on this nice Joel DeProw boot. Yeah, good boot. Back to the three goes Antoine Vance. He fumbled the last time out. Runs into the pile and gets it out to the 25-yard line. 2:09 to play in the ball game.
All right, here we go. A little no huddle.
A lot of no huddle. They need the six. And the 2 points really do them any good, trailing by 12. So if they can get a quick seven, they'll need another score to pull this one out. So advantage Raiders in that respect, yeah. That even if they get a quick six and the two-point conversion, that makes it 34-30, yeah. And the lead is four. So that was a huge touchdown by Racine. Makes it a real uphill climb here for the Bulldogs. First and 10 from the 24. Budzutski and company. Gonna see shotgun and a lot of this. Into heavy traffic and picked off.
Got a flag here.
Flags fly, flag. Picked off by Eric Feast for the second time tonight, but we'll see if it stands.
Oh, it's against the Bulldogs, look like it appears. See what we got here. Oh, that's a play there. What did he call?
They threw it right to Feast.
Right.
Two flags flew in that general vicinity.
I think he went to the head with the elbow, but I'm not quite sure.
Donald Woods, the intended receiver over there, and the officials continue to sort things out. Mike Brewer over there throwing the first flag, conferring with the head referee.
You saw the Racine Raiders down on that particular play. They went to their dime package, looked like they appeared they had two extra defensive backs back there, which is probably what you want to be in when you're on this type of situation.
Now the call, pass interference.
Pass interference against?
I believe they call it on number 20, Darrell Overstreet.
Oh, come on. That's not good.
Not good for the Raiders.
No. They get another play, man, that's even worse.
Now a break for the Bulldogs. First and 10 to 38, 2:02 to go in the ball game.
So then they back it here, Racine Raiders off.
Budzutski under center, scrambles, rolls, fires it deep.
Oh, he stopped running.
Calvin Thomas intended down there. The Raiders got back in a hurry. That ball underthrown. Thomas continued to run, but had to run back Gary Ellerson to try and retrieve that football.
I don't know if Tracy Baskin kind of gave up on the play a little bit, kind of stopped, ran right past him. You got to stay on top of that, Tracy.
All that incomplete. Second and 10.
All right, we got 2 minute warning here, bud.
Indeed, the 2 minute warning, 1:53 actually to play in the football game. And the Bulldogs down by 12. They'll have to go to the air like that last play and hope for something to happen. Pass interference helps, but they got on the last play, nothing doing.
You know, I would say the Racine Raiders, you know, after halftime, came back out in halftime. They kind of sorted things out a little bit. The linebackers started containing. Secondary played a lot tougher. I mean, they didn't get after them with many big plays like they did in the first half.
So we're ready to go.
Guess what they're going to do, Bob? Think they're going to throw the ball?
Yeah, they have to throw the ball. Down by a dozen. Second and 10. Budzutski.
Nice coverage. Nice coverage, boys.
Nowhere to go. Has to keep it and then knocked out of bounds with authority by, oh, I can guess,
Foles.
Jamie Isom.
Fours. 44.
They call him Ice.
Oh, yes. See, them quarterbacks don't get in the weight room enough. You can't be running up against a linebacker like that.
Did you know that? Played baseball in the Florida Marlins system.
Oh, he did?
Yeah. He had a shoulder injury, cut his baseball career short, so he went back to football. I think he made a good call.
Well, you can play with a bad shoulder in football. You can't in baseball.
No.
In football, you can.
Football, you encourage them a bad shoulder.
Yes, there you go.
Toughens you up.
Baseball, you get a hangnail, you got to come out.
Third down and two. Send your Gary Ellerson, baseball fans. Budzutski, incomplete. Intended for his fullback, Tim Booth. And he can't hook up. It would have got them the first down to keep the chains moving and the drive moving. But now, with 1:38 to play, they need to get 2 yards just to stay on the football field.
Let's see what they do here. You know, they can almost, if they wanted to, and then they didn't substitute, they can almost run the football and get a first down. Timeouts left.
All right. Chance to keep hopes alive for the Bulldogs on fourth and two from the 46. Budzutski, little flip, that's tipped it at the line. Defensive play made there by 42, Audrey Jarrett from Waukegan, Illinois High School. And that, folks, will do it.
Just might do it. They're going to run a couple plays to get out of here. That's where you get your hands up, folks, too. That's where you get your hands up.
So Audrey, with the big 6'5 frame, got the hands up. It paid off. Fourth down, thwarted. And the Racine Raiders just need to run a couple plays, run the second clock, yep, and they will have victory number one of the season. Do we have a timeout, or are they going to reset the clock?
I don't know what they're doing. There's a timeout call.
Water buckets are going out, so a timeout called. Brett Statema is back in there at quarterback to finish this one off for the Raiders. Racine will be on the road for the next couple of weeks. Give these guys a chance to water the field.
Yeah, they need a little bit of water out there.
It's been tough
thick
on the lawn.
But it's thick, though. That's thick grass out there, though. So
yeah,
you know, it's growing. Just a different shade of green.
Yeah. Well, whose grass does look green?
Mine.
In southeast Wisconsin.
Mine does.
You're lying.
Okay.
You're lying. You can water all day and can't keep up. Mother Nature needs to have a downpour or two. All right, Statema under center. Bulldog's going to bring it, trying to cause a
stay
fumble.
Stay in bounds, big boy. Don't, there you go. All right, okay. There you go.
This does stay in bounds. Keeps the clock rolling here. We're 1:20 to go. But the Bulldogs, a good showing here. Formerly the Milwaukee Bulldogs, now under the Wisconsin Bulldogs. They reside in Milwaukee.
They can take the victory formation here, Bob. The victory formation.
Would seem to be the play to call from the play chart. Statement just going to hand off to the big fullback, Makara. And now timeout called by, was it Racine? So third down play coming up. Well, Gary, I'm sure we'll be back for more Racine Raiders football throughout the season and get a chance to see some of the other teams.
Let me know.
In this league.
Oh,
I'll let you know. I'm not doing this solo. Are you kidding me? Third down and one. Chance to get the first down and officially ice this game away. We hope to head down to Travis Kavinsky and hear from the winning squad, the Raiders head coach. That's Jamal Cannon getting the first down and then some.
He's getting some subs and then to get a little work. Nothing wrong with that.
Get the uniforms dirty.
Nothing wrong with that. They practice a couple times a week just like everybody else.
Yeah, it's great to go through the bios of really anybody in this league and see where these guys came from and where they've played and, mm-hmm. and what they're doing now. You know, a lot of times they list profession, including a lot of the Raiders, and it's fun to see what these guys do for a living and in real life, so to speak. But a couple times a week, they they put the pads on and the helmets on and practice and then get ready for game night. And as Gary and I said at the top of the broadcast, keep the dream alive. Francis, gonna just fall on the football. And that will do it.
That may do it, Bob. All right.
So the final score tonight, the Racine Raiders put a W on the board to kick off their 2007 season. They win it with a big second half. The final score, 34-22. Over the Wisconsin Bulldogs. Let's send it down to Travis Kavinsky now. He's with the Raiders head coach, Jordan Kopack. And victory number one. Go ahead, guys.
Travis Kavinsky here with coach Jordan Kopack. The Raiders just pulled off a win 34-22 over the Wisconsin Bulldogs. Coach, what do you have to say about the game? What adjustments did you make in the second half to come out with this much of a victory?
Well, in the locker room during halftime, I beat up the safeties because those passes they were throwing are prime for interceptions. We came out the second half and we intercepted them. There's no reason they should be catching those passes, and that's going to be the end of it for this year, of catching those kind of passes.
What were your thoughts overall of the game of the Wisconsin Bulldogs?
Well, I thought they did a good job. I appreciated them coming here and doing as good a job as they did, and of course we're going to see them again.
Absolutely.
And we played our backup quarterback so we could get some time in, and because he hadn't played in the beginning of the season.
Okay. Well, thank you, Jordan. Appreciate it. Congratulations on the win. Back to the booth.
There you go, buddy. Coach is, when he's beating up the guys in the line halftime, you better listen, and they did listen. Final score, Racine 34 and Wisconsin 22. For my partner, Gary Ellerson, and our entire outstanding broadcast crew, we bring you the second half highlights. And it was an entertaining game from start to finish.
From start to finish, Bob, there was a lot of action going on. And the Wisconsin Bulldogs just wouldn't go away. And right here, take it to the house.
Yeah, that was Antoine Burns. And at the time, it swayed the momentum in favor of the Wisconsin Bulldogs. But the Raiders stayed with it and gave hometown faithful something to cheer about as Jennings, the big workhorse all night long, got the TD down. Palmer got that touchdown there. Yep. And then the game, the capper right here, Jennings, to end it.